My character came about because I asked Liam, I didn't know anything about Dungeons & Dragons, and I asked Liam, what's the dumbest character? And he said probably a bard. And I was like, what's the weakest character? And he said, I don't know, like a gnome. And I went to Dungeons & Dragons name generator, and that's how I found the name.
No, no. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I totally half-assed it.
Were you hoping to die in like one session so you could come back?
Well, we were all gonna just play once for his birthday, and then that was it. So I was like, yeah, I'll just be a dumb character. And then it turns out I'm the best one.
Yo, chance, you wanna dance? I'll enhance my answer. Rhymes so radioactive that they'll give you cancer. I'm the Kingslayer, the Mind Flayer. You're a chicken and my kitchen staff is gonna fillet ya.
Do you need any help?
Sure, you can come with
no,
us.
No, I don't want you to say yes. Grog and I go in search of a, shall we say politely, whorehouse. Is Grog gonna find someone his size?
I'm making some really nice.
I'll take a dwarf.
Okay.
Am I currently being beaten by a whore dwarf right now?
You have impressed your female dwarf.
Are you making a sex joke?
By the yes.
Oh. How was your night?
That was wonderful. I don't know about you.
I have hiccups. I start playing music from my shawm. instrument, which exists.
Yeah, it does.
Bear dancing theme.
Oh, look over there, it's a bear.
You see, next to the door, there is a small chain.
Should we ding-dong ditch?
No.
I'll start singing a little jaunty welcoming song. Hello, right. Hello, we're here to pay you calling. Hello, hello. I don't know what rhymes with calling. I'm going to turn invisible.
As he's looking over there, he just
you are
vanish. All right,
and
I'm
sneaking into the house.
Oh,
to what end?
To what end? No way!
Closes the large oak door. You are now standing in the foyer of House Greyspine.
Fucking foreigners.
I follow him where he's going.
Okay.
My nervousness. I let out a little bit of a fart as we
make a stealth check.
I might as well try one of the doors that's locked and see if I can pick it, but I'm not good at that, so okay. I'll try.
Okay, do you have, or have you have in your person any sort of thieves' tools?
I have a forgery kit, a poisoner's kit.
Yes!
Forge some thieves' tools real quick.
Climbing gear. And a whip.
Man, I have bit one of the earrings, and I say, Scanlan, what exactly is the purpose for this little escapade, and will it be ending shortly?
Just trust me that I have no idea what I'm doing. I become uninvisible, and I cast Dimension Door.
All right. You blink through this small, kind of purplish arcane doorway. It brings you directly outside. You guys are waiting. Gonna just pops into view.
Holy oh, God. God. Oh, it was crazy in there. People were farting everywhere. Really? It was not me.
Really, Scanlan?
They're building a throne room. There were some locked doors. Man, I wish you could have been there. It was exciting, but ultimately pointless. So let's go down to the mall.
And you start seeing small, green, scampering things rushing through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. 10 goblins come rushing out of the tunnel.
We
should attack.
Fellows,
okay.
I don't like goblins.
18.
I don't like goblins.
Is there anything?
I think you're really handsome and nice. You're going to have inspiration dice.
You can add it to an attack roll, a saving throw.
Yeah.
There you go.
24
points of lightning damage.
Yes.
Kill it.
I don't want to do this.
Yeah!
Wait, is it the first time?
I've never killed anything in 2 years!
So you sing to yourself to bolster your arcane energy. You release.
Th- the bolt of lightning begins in its tail and works its way up through its spine, slowly but painfully torturing it as it slowly yes. feels the effect coursing through its evil body. can it have a lightning bolt shaped in an S?
A scandal is just like a bolt that's just burned into the torso of the strange Naga beast.
Well done, Scanlan! Well done!
All the rest of the dwarves begin stepping down, putting their crossbows down, looking down at the little gnome that created a storm from its hands. And kind of one of them pats him on the shoulder and goes, well done.
Thank you. Just promise me that you'll tell Pike about this.
Okay.
Because it was really cool, right? I will sing a song of rest. And it goes a little something like, Scanlan make you feel good. Scanlan make you feel real good.
Many goblins stitched together as some kind of ball of screaming green limbs.
Like a goblin centipede.
Or it sounds like a bit of...
if you will, aye.
Sounds more like some type of necromancy.
Perhaps, but they're not undead per se. They're still alive.
We just killed one of those.
That was you!
Yeah, yes. our hero is right over here.
Hi.
Really?
I'm really strong for my age.
Well, that'd be last. You're welcome to stay as long as you like. I don't get visitors too often up here in my booth. I've got some meats inside. I've got two chairs, and you can fit in my lap, and he kind of pats you on the head.
I've killed.
Right.
The Valve of Valva, what is it? Valor of...
The
Valva...
Yeah, no.
That's not the House of Valva, Scanlan.
It's Value of Valor.
The Value of Valor.
If you want to visit the House of Valva, you will have to meet later.
All right, we go into the House of Valva. Open your Valva!
That's not... It's called.
The other one, who is attacking Grog.
No, motherfucker, miss! I start singing using my cutting words reaction.
All right. That brings it to a 17.
18.
Woo!
Oh, you saved your
life!
I will cast Polymorph on our big friend that we're surrounding. And I'll turn him into a snail.
A snail? Aww.
All right.
Can you do that?
That rears back and begins to unleash a series of attacks and then into this tiny snail form on the ground.
I've seen where
it arcs off into the distance.
Oh, 17.
17 will just barely hit.
Yes! Well done. Well done.
8d6?
Yeah.
8?
Yeah.
Yes.
Shit.
The crawling fingers of electricity kind of shoot through its plates.
I like crawling fingers.
To the one who shot it with the angry lightning bolt. This tiny gnome that now is a delicious morsel in the mandibles of an Umber Hulk. It comes running forward like a giant, like armored gorilla.
Oh no.
That hits three times.
Yep. 38 points of slashing damage.
This is the sound I make.
It's looming over you, ready to try and finish you off next round.
I'm just gonna stick both knives into his guts and says, no one touches the gnome!
How do you want to do this?
I'm gonna stick it in the back of his spider nads, spill it all out the bottom.
So
I'm right next to him, it might spill on me.
Zip. You rush underneath, tumble, bringing your dagger up and slam it right under the bottom of its abdomen. Its now soft torso and belly left open from the armor plates being shot off spills a number of its warm innards right onto Scanlan's body and form.
I went in my mouth!
And then it collapses on top of him. You take 6 points of crushing damage. As the Umber Hulk collapses on top
I run over and shove the Umber Hulk off of Scanlan.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
What just happened?
I go over to Scanlan and I just lay my hands on him and I cast Cure Wounds in a level 2 spot.
Nobody touches my man wife.
You should get in the water and clean yourself off.
We have running water.
I think I want to keep it on.
You know, it's clean already.
It's a badge of honor.
It's a badge of honor.
Like the Walking Dead.
I think I'm gonna keep the blood on me if you don't mind.
All right.
All right.
That's okay.
Cast stinking cloud right there. It's gonna smell like just ass. Over there.
A giant
ass cloud.
Green. Ooh. Ass cloud. Constitution saving throws. Everything in the cloud.
Grog, can you hear us?
I rush down and
can you feel us near you?
Times.
Someone, quick.
On
his face.
I also bend down and slap him.
We can both go on the carpet.
What if something happens?
We just gotta see where they're going
I'm
and we'll come back and get you.
You.
Alright.
Guys, you lay out the carpet. The two of you get on.
Oh, yes.
And grab Scanlan by the scruff of his neck.
The three of you guys hop on it. It's about big enough for the three of you. It's
shotgun.
About the right size.
Okay. Listen. Leave me behind. I'll follow the party that with the hostages. I'll see where they go. Don't worry, I'll be invisible.
Okay. Scanlan!
I like
what?
It.
I'm super brave and hung. Come on, let's do this.
All right. I'm down. Should we do it?
All right.
Just hang behind the party that's got the hostage dwarves and
should
just kind
of
see where they
him?
Go.
Do you activate hung at the same time?
Invisible.
Don't have to activate.
We can't go invisible. Okay. We can't be.
How big was this mud flayer? Was he like 20 feet tall, Scanlan?
Oh, he was tall. I mean, everyone looks 20 feet tall to me. Hey, baby. Hey, baby.
But
hey,
we need to.
Dwarves say. Dwarves say. Hey, baby. Hey, baby. Run to the bridge and fall down.
Hey. You can see an actual small tunnel that's carved into the Mount Rock.
Fuck off, y'all, bitches.
Oh, we're not going down here. It doesn't do anything yet. We don't know.
Let's go into the tunnel.
Meanwhile, back up top, I'm saying, they're not going to find anything.
Yeah.
They're not going to find anything.
And I'm agreeing with Scanlan, and I am mooning.
Clarota.
What's his name?
Clarota.
Clarota.
Can we just call him Clarence? I'd love to play you just a little bit of a song that might heal some of those wounds and scrapes that you seem to have all over your body.
It gives you the dirtiest look you've ever received.
It was because of the arcane.
It's a pretty good song.
Make a persuasion check.
Ooh, 17.
It takes a sudden step forward towards you, its tentacles.
Play this song.
Break out the.
It better be good.
When I get that feeling, I want Clarota healing. Clarota healing is something that's good for you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ah, ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, 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 oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, persuasion. Oh, 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 a performance check.
A performance check. 18.
Oh, we all got so groovy.
In spite of itself, it stands there still glaring at you. But at the corner of your eye, you swear you see its toe tapping.
I'm gonna go take a look. Scanlan, come on.
I'm coming with.
Okay. Both of you guys roll stealth?
9!
29.
Alright.
That's a number.
As you officially vanish into the ether and the surrounding darkness, Scanlan, who still has that song stuck in his head from earlier, his slow jam.
Grab Scanlan, put my hand over his mouth, and say, quiet, man, what's wrong with you? It's a nervous habit, I'm sorry. With great power comes great responsibility.
It's a gift I have to share with the world. Lady Kima, the one we're trying to find.
Lady Kima.
How did you know that?
Me and Pike are like.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow. It's so great to see you.
It's
you
really
look
great to
fantastic,
see you.
By the way.
I don't
way.
Feel fantastic.
Bring it in. Bring it in. Give me a hug. Give me a hug. Ooh, you smell a little. I like it, though.
It
works. Somehow it works on you. Oh, yes. Down below in the waters, our allies, Vex and somebody. Saw some creatures under the water snatching bodies as they fell.
I'm sharpening my axe.
Good, good.
It is good.
I'm just doing my vocal warm-ups.
All right.
Me, 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 me. Oh, I'm gonna sing a little ditty to inspire Vax. I didn't see the vax, cause he's so goddamn stealthy. La da 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 da. Okay.
Was that a high swap of size?
Yes, yeah.
We are probably going to die today. It has been an honor.
It has been an honor.
You won't
if
die
only
tonight.
One of us will die.
By the way, Vax.
And it won't be me.
When we get up there,
I can be invisible. I'm so scared right now.
If we go down really fast, it's hard to go to the map.
Why don't we land on the roof and we all lay flat except for the people that are going in, you cast invisibility.
This is the exact conversation they had when they were about to go kill Osama.
I still have we're going like a dark cloud.
I have a climbing kit.
We're in.
Okay, it's a little late for that, but okay.
I pull Scanlan by the hand and we enter into this room.
This is so romantic.
All right.
It's just like the day we met, Sam. Put the bucket of shit into Scanlan's hands.
What are you doing with
him? And give him a little nudge, gentle little nudge.
I step forward into the room and I hurl it at the fucker's face.
You fling it as the invisibility spell wears off of you as part of the attack. You
no.
Fling the bucket. A spray of thick, gooey goblin fecal matter goes streaking through the air as the Illithid turns with its eyes wide to see you suddenly appear and then suddenly see this entire batch of thick goblin shit just push across its face. 8 points of damage from the war pick, slamming you over the shoulder.
Ah, I'm so awesome, Pike! Okay, I'm gonna cast Dominate Person on the general.
What does that do?
With advantage, you rolled a 1 and a 2 on the saving throw.
Yes! Oh!
That's ridiculous.
And
okay.
I'm going to dominate him and inform him. I can give him a command, right?
Yes.
You can make him do whatever.
I'm going to tell him to stand down and tell all of his allies to stand down.
Men, all of you, drop your weapons. Now, we are surrendering to our new infiltrators.
Clarota slowly drifts
down. Oh yeah, Clarota, thanks for all the fucking help.
This Durgar is going to move up back to you, Scanlan, as it sees that you were the one that took over the general now.
Bring it.
All right, this one is actually also physically growing in size as it comes towards you.
He's getting hard.
Yeah. Around you, always.
16.
I'm going to run away from the guy behind me, run straight at the general, and just open out my arms in an outstretched big hug, and I'm like, come here, big guy. Come here, and I give him a big hug, and upon touching him, I cast Banishment on him and send him to another dimension.
Nice!
All right!
As you move away,
The Duergar is going to attempt to make, as a reaction, to make an attack on you.
It's okay, it's all cool for Pike.
That's going to be a 13 versus armor class.
Does not hit!
You just hear it coming as you're walking, buddy! He has his war pick ready, pulls back its war pick as the flames burst in, and then blinks out of existence.
Nice move.
One down.
He's gone! Oh, where did he go? I don't know. I'm just gonna sing a little ditty, you know, to Pike, just to give her a little inspiration. I'm just gonna do some pelvic thrusting, a little. That's a flute, by the way.
All right. There you go.
Super impressive. Play that, Pike.
Landing right on top of Clarota and Scanlan.
Oh no!
Clarota fails.
20.
It's okay, Scanlan. It's okay. You can do this. Makes a bite attack against Scanlan.
I distract him. With my playing my charm.
You take 41 points of piercing damage.
Holy shit.
Oh my God. Scanlan! No worries, I'm just at negative 36 now.
Really?
Yep.
Okay. So
that's a good idea.
Wait. The grog hand. Scanlan, how did that happen?
He's unconscious, he's in bad shape, but
yeah.
We're gonna get him.
Scanlan's looking rough. Scanlan is now being just thrashed around in the mouth of the creature. His limp gnome arms and legs just woof. Strings of gnome blood are being flung across the room.
He's so little though.
Pike, your toe. At what level are you
don't
using?
Don't chintz out.
I'm gonna use it.
Cast whatever you can
cast. One or multiple people.
Can you do it at a higher level?
Yeah, I'll do it at my highest level that I can cast, which is...
Let's not cheap out on Scanlan.
Fifth level would be, yeah.
Sorry, guys.
So now I'm at 23?
It's an automatic fail.
Now you're 23.
So now you're 23 hit points.
Hey, I feel great, guys!
You're still in its mouth being shook around?
Oh, shit! What is this ride? This is crazy!
If you'd like me to hold your armor, do you want to take it off for a little while?
I'll keep it on just for safety.
Let it hang out a little bit, you know? Just saying. Might feel more comfortable with a loose-fitting sort of clothes.
Scanlan, stop being creepy.
Trapdoor?
That's a trapdoor.
Yeah.
You have
possible...
under the
magma?
You missed a lot, Scanlan.
Yes. I was with you the whole time.
We know. Here, because the general that we mind-melded, Clarota read his brain. Yeah.
Yeah, I was there.
I know. So I'm reiterating.
Yeah. Good. Thank you for that.
Yes.
Just making sure.
You had this.
So remember, Scanlan, that the general said that on the left side of the fortress
of
is
the
how
fortress.
We can get into the
how
trap door.
How we can get into the trap door.
Right.
Exactly.
By the smaller of two levels.
What?
Lava flows.
So careful as you move through.
Yeah. How long would it take you?
Yes, it's very dark. The only reason you can see much is because of the light vision.
Very
even
long.
At this radius, things you can
see. It's either a 6 or a 9.
15.
No idea.
There's a dot on the bottom.
Oh, that's the bottom?
Yeah.
It's a 6.
The twins are going to go have a peek.
Okay.
I'm coming with.
Do it.
Scanlan comes with. Go ahead and roll stealth check.
Oh boy. Not my strong suit.
Don't fuck it up.
No, Scanlan, what'd you do?
You dick.
Did you?
What did you do?
You can change your mind.
Wait,
I got advantage. Don't die.
I grab Scanlan and I kiss him on the cheek and make him stay.
What?
Unfortunately, you're not quite perceptive enough to notice Scanlan's not quite so quiet walking away. You continue up with the twins. Absent-mindedly humming to yourself. The twins being used to your humming, for some reason it doesn't connect.
Scanlan, shh!
What?
You're singing.
I was singing? Are you singing? I didn't even know! It's a force of habit!
Like, arms and limbs were wrenched from the body just out of sheer power. Toothy fangs, sharp teeth have partially eaten portions of these bodies.
This is the work of a beaver.
Yes, definitely.
A busy beaver.
I think it's suicide.
Should we? I mean, based on. Yeah,
I'm really bad at stealthing. We should go. We should leave.
Also, put the accordion back in the show, all right?
Was I doing that? It's force of habit. I don't. Pike, I have this weird feeling like you wanted to make out with me. Is that something that happened
well,
in my dream?
Well, you know, you weren't paying attention.
Really?
And that makes you want to make out with him? No, I think you were moving along to try to go stealth, and sometimes you should just stay put and see what happens.
Well said, cleric.
All right.
Yet inviting.
It's all right, Scanlan. We'll go pay for it later.
Have the party go ahead and roll a communal stealth check once more.
I rolled a 1.
Okay.
I quickly kiss Percy. I don't know. I thought it might help. I polymorph and turn into a fly, and I buzz over to him.
Nice.
Oh yay!
All right.
That's
yum
nuts. Fun.
You approach this individual and notice it is unmoving and is of a singular solid color. An illithid or mind flayer is currently locked in some sort of a reactionary position.
I buzz back to the group.
Maybe you should.
Clarota lags behind a little bit to inspect the statue and just kind of looks it over for a second.
Did you know him?
Dave.
God damn it. An instant later, you guys are both standing at the top of the wall with both of the Duergar, one kind of facing away, one looking really surprised at the fact that you guys both appeared there. You have a surprise round. What are you doing?
I cast Thunder Wave and blast out from where I'm standing between them.
As you guys appear, you release Pike, you bring your arms up and slam your arms kind of in a downward motion. As you do, there is a dull flash of light and a boom, a burst sound that emanates from you. The one who sees you, who's bringing up his crossbow to fire, gets impacted and blown off the side of the wall. The one facing away gets blown up towards, slams into the side of the wall right at the edge, and then topples over the side.
I didn't have to do anything, Scanlan!
make out with me. We're alone. It's super romantic. I just killed Tupac. Come on. Oh, no. It's now or never, baby. Give a little inspiration to Vax.
Yeah.
That's Laura, obviously.
Yeah, thank you.
It's inverted. All right.
Guys, I'm sensing a lot of purple and brown construction paper here.
If this is indeed Lady Kima, you now see why she's made the reputation she has.
I sing, as long as I got my song and flute, I'm gonna give some healing to you. Love and magic in the air tonight. Gonna give you some hit points. Gonna give you some hit points. Yeah. Gonna give you some hit points of balance.
All right, I'll step ahead and go invisible.
The two of
we're
you.
Walking down a hall, nobody's watching us.
As you're humming to yourself.
Oh no!
It's fine.
Kima, do you see any of your equipment here that you wanted?
No, nothing's here.
Can't you just take one of these things and call it a day?
She glares in the direction of your voice.
I'm invisible.
Right. The trinket?
Oh, gosh.
Trinket's dex modifier.
Okay. Yo, good. 11.
11. All right, so as you guys are...
Because I'm invisible in the thing with Lady Kima, I kind of get up on a stool to see if I can catch some cleavage. Kind of like, just peek over, peek in.
The leather armor that she wore is a full torso covering leather armor piece. I apologize.
I give up. I'm looking, can I look around the guest bedroom? Just kind of snoop around under things.
Right. Sure. Scanlon, you staying in that room?
I'm taking a dump on the guest bed.
I like walk by the door and see that happening.
I'm gonna
But also just light. Covering it up with the blanket after.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay.
Well, you're in mid process. This is all happening pretty quickly.
I'll go.
I'm invisible. It's
okay. Poop. Carrying you. You guys are actually kind of like pinched off in the hallway right here. So as you guys are
don't
all
say
kind of
pinched off to me. I can't see him, then I will just yell at him.
All right.
I'll yell with vicious mockery.
Yes.
I don't like you very much for poisoning me and my friends. You're a poopy head.
So vicious. So.
That does 7 points of damage.
7 points of damage vicious mockery. Yes. Yeah. All right. The currently fearful Duergar mage kind of glances eyesight about, hears these words, and you see him rack his head for a second with sudden sense of self-loathing and disappointment.
I'd like you to sing to me, either in the game or on another day.
Are you Vex or Vax? Heal the Vax, make him a better elf, for you and for me and the entire adventuring band. There are Duergar dying. If you cared enough for the adventurers, you'd bring Vax back to help us with the stabby stab. I do have an idea about gaining the upper hand on our first meeting with this army that's upstairs, an intimidation technique of some sort.
Yes.
Some of these Duergar bastards are scared of that strange chimera sort of hodgepodge human centipede
Frankenstein thingy.
We could be one of those with a little bit of deception and all of us sort of piling on each other. We could act like a big scary monster and go up and freak the fuck out of them.
You can run reconnaissance ahead.
That's actually a really good idea.
They would probably be at least for the moment
intimidated
a bit, and we could get a few licks in before they realized we're just a pile of idiots running like that. Hi, Scanlan here.
Scanlan, you know how to harness the power.
I mean, I don't want
electricity.
I don't want to brag, but I'm a regular Ben Franklin over here. He's a guy. He's a gnome I knew.
Scanlan, go.
I say, you ugly. You ugly. Your mama says you ugly. You ugly. You ugly. Your mama says you ugly. And I cast vicious mockery on him. Just five.
How much did you do? A total?
32 total.
As the Duergar is currently held aloft in this aquatic sphere, half charred and burnt with pieces of his friends floating, in the water around him, he hears through this kind of warbling sound, "You want me? You want me?" And he sees everyone kind of step out in the hallway clapping with you, and he kind of looks around at himself, looks at his situation, and eventually just gives up and takes a big old gulp of water and drowns inside the aquatic sphere.
Yes! I shamed him to death.
Yeah. Amazing. What a terrible way to die.
Good news is,
I want to sing a song of inspiration, of inspiration.
Okay. Swinging at Scanlan.
As he does, I sing, dodge that sexy attack, go white boy. I mentally tell him that he really has the urge to try to do a headstand. Lay down his weapon, and he really just wants to see if he can do it.
He glances back towards you with a look of confusion for a second, looks at his feet, and like begins to reach forward, and then steals his mind and looks up at you angrily.
You can attack him with your sword.
Hit him with a flute. I am a tiny boy.
Do it anyway. He's at his last legs.
I can't cure Grog.
This is gonna be epic, Scanlan.
I will say that. I can't.
Come on, quick. Right.
I swing my singing Dawn Blade at him.
Dawn? Yeah. All right.
I have a Dawn Blade.
Alrighty.
It's a Dawn.
Dong Blade.
A natural 20.
We said he could roll 20. We called it. Who called it?
I've never hit anyone with a sword before. I don't know, what am I adding? I've never used a sword before.
Proficiency modifier, which is 4 plus your strength modifier. So it's 5 of that, which is 10. Makes it 20.
20.
Which hits. Roll damage on the
Boom.
Oh my god.
Kill him.
6.
6 points of damage, or 6 on that.
On that
plus
one.
Your strength, which is 1, 7. Plus the Dawn Blade, which is, that's 8.
23 or
so it's 8. 8 damage on top of the 23. How do you want to do this?
As I draw back the blade, I say, oh, you should have stood on your head, and I lop it off. Let's just make a decision right now to leave Grog and continue on.
What? No.
Let's just forget about him. He was a good friend.
What?
We'll have a toast to him.
Scanlan,
we'll sing about songs
said.
Of his memory.
Scanlan. You are shitting with us, right?
Within a few days, we'll forget he ever
Scanlan,
existed.
Scanlan, no one else wants to go to a whole house with you. You'll be going to whole houses alone.
All right,
alone.
Fine.
Yes,
fine.
No more.
I'm going to sing while you heal, if that's all right.
Ooh,
with you.
Please do.
Whatever. Okay, ready? Oh, wherever you go. Whatever damage they've done, we will be right here waiting to kill
brother.
You. No matter what hit points you take, or how your foot breaks, we will be right here waiting to kill you.
All that improv school payoff.
Yes. Lady Kima, Clarota, may I suggest you take the first watch?
Oh my god, what if they start fucking?
Soon it's gonna be that sort of evening. Excellent.
Pike, I'll cuddle you for warmth if that would help.
It's already so hot in here with all the lava and stuff. Okay. I would just prefer to sleep alone. I'm sorry.
That's fine.
Good night.
That's fine. That's what I meant.
Yeah.
Scanlan, I am very cold.
You know what? We better let that foot heal. We better let it heal. I'm just gonna blind the bitch. So I cast blindness on her.
Okay, what's the range on that?
It's a girl. It's a her.
Isn't it a girl?
What? No, it's a male elf.
Yeah, well, I'm so demeaning to it. I call a girl.
Why is that demeaning?
Because it is a chauvinist, and I know that just by looking at it.
It's a chauvinist.
I'm prone.
So what's the range on that, Scanlan?
Oh, I'm looking.
Disadvantage on his roll.
You're in the wrong group to be saying that shit, man. I'm drunk.
Whatever!
So you can wait for her to pull you closer.
I will wait for that, though.
Okay,
so
cool. Okay.
And I love women.
Okay.
Oh, you
we know,
yeah, Scanlan.
We know.
Biblically.
Underneath us.
Okay.
I'm making a dance floor.
That was an excellent move by a strong, independent woman who doesn't need a man to tell her what to do.
What to do.
I give a little inspiration to Pike. I just look over her, give her a little wink. A little smile. It's all it takes.
Good on
you.
All it takes.
Come closer to me.
I'll stay.
All right.
Because she's an independent woman.
That's a proud choice, and I honor and respect it. I have no ranged attacks. except I can viciously mock it. So that's what I'll do.
Do it.
I'll say, you know what? Your tentacles make you look kind of fat. And the elf thing is played out. It's sort of 1990. Orlando Bloom. And the whole bone thing is just really tacky. I look over at Liam and I do one of, I mean, sorry, Vax, and do one of these things.
All right, you are strangely inspired by that.
Sorry, guys.
That's a lot of math.
You know what? Women are good at math.
They are.
Wow, that was
exciting. I know what we're going to do.
Oh and, my gosh.
And I feel like empowering to a lot of the
females.
I think I've got a plan.
Oh, because I did too.
You have a plan.
No, I want to hear yours. Plans.
So let's do them both without telling and just see what happens. Okay. She could slip through while we're drawing them out and get through and let him go in the midst of the fight.
That works with my plan.
That works with your plan.
My plan was to go in there and distract them while you did something.
Fantastic. Perfect plan.
I like that plan.
Yeah. Oh, no, in this case, intimidation, I think is what this is going to be.
Do I roll again?
I'll say okay because it is a different skill.
Queen Ulara, if I may have a word. Let us spare each other lots of bloodshed and just have a chat before we fight. Is that all right?
Reynolds. Talk, small, annoying creature, and perhaps it'll delay the inevitable.
We, my friends and I, have
Hello.
Come... Hi, yes. We've come from the above world, the normal world, let's say, to your fine kingdom down here below. And we were on a mission. We're a bit of, I don't want to brag, but we're a bit of an elite task force sent in by kingdoms and kings that you probably haven't heard of way down below. But anyway, I'll spare you. M'lady, we have come on a mission to save someone that you were held in captive. We have completed our mission. And in the melee in that hovel you called a palace back there, We lost one of our own, and we would like him back. Now, I'll make it very simple, because my fellows are begging me to keep things simple. It's a simple binary choice. You can all die right now, or you can turn over our friend, and we will probably leave you in peace. I would promise, but I don't make promises to dogs.
Oh, shit!
I'm gonna just bum-rush the queen.
Yes! All right.
And just dive right there.
All right.
Just dive full head on straight for her and bear hug her with banishment.
Yeah. Oh yeah, baby!
I love banishment.
Okay. You charge forward, you pull out your enchanted hand cone and shout the incantation towards her with an angry glare.
Get lost, motherfucker!
it's not you, it's me! I don't know. Where does it say?
It should say what saving throw it is.
Find it.
I will do this for you. This would have been a very dangerous round if you hadn't have connected with her right in the front of her clavicle, completely caught off guard, frustration, before her entire form blinks out of existence and is no longer visible on the board.
Bardash.
Yes!
Get the hell out of there.
Give inspiration to Grog, because he needs it.
All right. Okay. So, Grog, as the flames die down, you look over and watch Scanlan just rush up and completely, as far as you know, disintegrate the Duergar queen.
Wow.
with that, he looks over you and gives you a little wink and a smile. Go ahead and take an inspiration dice, which for him is now a d10.
Oh!
Duergar swings at you with his war pick. That is...
Oh, don't hit me! I cast a little cutting words?
Yep, so it's a
6. Oh, no!
Can't take you anymore.
It was a 4.
It was a 4, so it takes that down from 60 to a 12, which does miss.
He misses!
So as he rushes towards you...
Oh, don't hit me!
He stops for a second, confused, like, but he puts the war pick down for a second, like... Wait,
You gnome!
Frustrated and angry that you caused him to somehow lower his guard and attack
your ass.
Kimmy,
can you take a walk with me? I would like to persuade you to take away.
Don't take his money.
Kima gives you a concerned look and goes,
It's just, there's this thing on my body. I thought maybe you could take a look at it and you could tell me if it's good or bad.
Oh dear. No. Please.
I use my minor illusion to create like a purple third nipple on me that I sort of show her and ask her if it's okay. Or if it's just kinda...
Okay, things are getting a little weird.
Is this normal?
None of this is normal. Oh, I'm not sure what this is. I'm sorry.
There's one more thing I need you to look at. It's just I cast polymorph on myself, giving myself a gigantic dick. And I slowly pull down my pants.
Kima immediately turns around and says, okay, and walks back to the group.
What did I say? What did I say? You can't keep it in for 2 seconds.
It's my way.
I mean, not that I blame you, my God.
Scanlon, what is that? Oh, this bulge down here.
That's bedtime is what that is. All right, everyone, let's go ahead and find ourselves a rest.
I check under below my belt because the spell has worn off, and I'm back down to my normal 1.5 inches. Which on a gnome
is pretty big.
It's pretty big.
It's pretty big.
All right.
Thank you.
Length and girth.
Oh God! What?
It's okay. Like a square.
Yeah, you're like, yes.
It's like a cube.
You're like a crushed coat.
Anyway.
All right.
Anyway.
I'm singing to help him, to inspire him. Oh, push it. Push it real good. Push it real good.
The passage is very, very thin. It can maybe fit you individually, barely fit Grog when you actually go through the passage properly.
It's pretty spacious in here, I think.
For a gnome, yes. This is a key point in time for a Scanlan song.
Oh, yes, I will inspire you. I don't know what to sing. What's a boat song?
Come on.
Yes, How does it start?
I'm not feeling very inspired.
Something exciting is waiting for you. I'm on a boat, motherfucker! That's all I got.
There you go.
I feel inspired. I'll give you D6 for that.
The boat going up to the beach?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yes. All right. I scoop up Scanlan and go piggyback style like he's my son. And jump on the beach.
Alright, 20 to 15.
16.
16 for Tiberius. Dum. 15 to 10.
Really strong 13.
Really, really. The bullet itself ricochets and spins off into the distance, into the darkness, but you do see left behind where part of the rock had chiseled from the impact. Ice has coalesced, cracked, and
I'm gonna conjure Barrage of Cone at them all once he's hunting.
Barrage of Cone?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sounds like an Sasha Italian porn guy.
Barrage of Cone!
Same damage your lightning bolt does.
That's sick. Oh, you're right. Man, I'm a bad man, Jim.
Gathering it up, you find approximately 420 gold pieces.
Awesome.
Yeah, 420. Yeah, baby.
That's hilarious.
Pike off the carpet?
I'm laying in the dirt
right
okay.
now.
Okay, I will jump off the carpet, grab her.
I'm too heavy.
And say, Pike, come with me if you want to live. And I just hold her really tight, and I snip her hair, and it smells like strawberries.
Gotta make it weird.
And then I dimension door us to the boat.
The two of you fall a few inches into hard wood, and you feel the boat rock for a second.
Damn, thanks!
Don't worry, that hard wood is the boat. I rolled a 2, but my wisdom is -2. So I'm at a 0. I'm gonna create a big hand right in front of it. To stop with the big B's hand.
All right.
It's this guy now. He's named Big B. He has a big hand.
You hear like the strange crushing sound of bones breaking on the inside of its strange.
This is the strongest I've ever been.
Hit it.
I sing. When you're trying to skin a cloaker, here's some inspiration. When we're on a creepy boat. Here's some inspiration.
I wanna be near me.
All right, that's
all right. I'm just gonna inspire her with a little, like, just a little, like a little dolphin dance or something.
His strange shimmy is slightly inspiring. You've learned something about yourself today.
I just sort of go near Lady Kima and I start humming. I'm gonna cast a suggestion on her.
Okay.
No makes you want to check out Grog's bod. No makes you want to check out his bod and sweat him so hard.
Is that B-52's?
Yes, yes it is.
I go over to the water and scoop up some and pour it over myself.
No, I mean no disrespect when I say toy with my mind again and you'll find the business end of this hammer right up your rectum.
Oh. That is a part that I need for shitting on beds, so I will. I apologize.
You bothered me enough recently with your antics.
Scry, scry, Miss Keelit, scry. Put your eyeballs to the cavern and tell us why. Oh.
Okay. Check. Can I use my flying stealth check? Damn it.
Nope.
Oh.
Three.
On with advantage.
That was my advantage. The first one was a one. Wait, plus two. That makes it five. Plus 10. That's 15.
And we're getting better.
Some sort of towering humanoid dragging something behind it.
There are giants in the sky.
Scanlan!
I hope you guys got my word that you did not try to capture him, did you?
No, we didn't, and everything's gone horribly wrong because
Wait, don't try to capture. No, don't capture him. That's a terrible idea.
You got me helped. Oh no, it's starting.
It's too late.
You
got this.
Beautifully.
16 for the first hit.
16, yeah.
Rock this bitch.
Right?
I get to do more?
Yes.
Oh, but he's a giant and I'm a little thing.
Yes, you are. Yes, he is.
I guess I should hit him. I'm gonna hit him with a lightning bolt.
Oh!
Break free. Can't do so. It's stuck where he is. He currently has nothing in range to attack.
Except for me.
No, you're 15 feet below. He doesn't have range on you at the moment. Because you are so small, you literally just stand there as the swing. The wind blows your hair back a little bit. But it's not fine purchase on your body.
Dainty nose!
Giant arcane fist of Scanlan. Pike, Tiberius, what are you doing?
I don't want to see the giant fist of Scanlan.
Many have before.
The giant takes a moment and his head nods slowly, like.
Is it like a French person?
Kind of, yeah. Like, okay. Manages to get the gist across.
I don't know what you're saying. Oh, I understand.
How do I say? I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
We rolled deep.
I speak Keelith. She's saying. She's saying that he should wait here until our instructions to attack. I'll sleep near you, Kima.
Her eyes for a moment seem to dart to your shoulder where you had previously shown her your awkward purple third nipple.
Farewell, Pike. I'll miss you.
Goodbye, my love!
What?
What?
What? My love?
It's from a movie that I saw.
What is it? I will inspire him.
Okay.
Thank you, please.
Everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're making an arrow.
Clarota turns to you slowly and says, piercing in your mind with a force of honesty and almost condescending essence.
You will make it 10 feet before the brain is pulled from your skull.
Yes. Typically it's yes and Clarota, but...
Can anybody shrink Trinket too?
Is Trinket worth it?
Scanlan?
Of course Trinket is worth it. I was saying, I was being Bizarro Scanlan.
Yeah.
You dropped the bomb on me.
Before it falls, baby, I would like
my boots of haste.
And okay, so I come to
Pike.
You with the inspiration.
Any buff spells you want to put on?
I stand, I look at the creature, No, I don't look at the creature. I just sort of look near the creature.
You're like, just kidding.
And I will punch it in its face with Bigby's hand.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
10.
10.
Right?
A total of 10?
Yeah.
Alright.
I'm gonna give Grog some more healing.
Alright.
Yeah. So now I come to you with healing words. Now you know what Grog? I don't know. Healing words.
Okay, so,
come on, Matt. Can't you remember where 10 people are at once?
11, technically.
And now I try to blind him.
All right.
Well, through the hand cone of clarity, of course.
All right.
Blinded by the light.
Yes.
Wrapped up like a douche.
Another rather than the night.
Roll a 20.
Didn't join me.
Fuck you.
It glances up at you just in time for you to release that final arrow. It strikes down.
I give some healing to Pike as well.
All right.
Hey, baby.
It's Lee.
Does
check it out.
You're Superman?
Yeah.
Does he talk like this?
Yeah, it gets a little weird around episode 3.
I cast fly on myself.
Okay.
Well, hold on.
Bye, Tiberius.
Hold on.
Clarota's tentacles wrap around your head.
Oh!
You immediately take 15 points of psychic damage, and you are currently grappled.
And stunned.
Yes.
Grappled and stunned. So grappled and stunned.
So go ahead and make your saving throw.
Come on, buddy.
Yes!
Yes!
Boom!
You shrug off the stunned effect. You're currently grappled by the entity.
You're so smart!
Cardiac bonus.
Not on Scanlan, on the one attacking Scanlan.
Oh, right, sorry. That's
what did I do?
As you're stunned, you feel the tentacles swirling around the back of your head. Teeth are grinding into the back of your skull, and you feel this horrible pain as all of a sudden, Rhoda's mouth is beginning to find a way towards your skull. And then the tentacles suddenly go limp. As the back of Florida's head.
Traitor!
A mess.
Traitor!
Psychic energy is just clutching her brain and holding it hostage.
She's still beautiful, though.
No.
I run up to Pike. I grab her hand. I say, I want to have babies with you. Let's get out of here. So now I come to you. With Dimension Door!
Fuck Lady Kima!
Yeah.
Sorry, she's not.
Yeah. Put her in the bag of holding!
She's heavy.
No!
She's stoned! It doesn't matter!
Don't do that! Finally shrug off the effect of the mind blast. Your eyes clarify.
Does she fall in love with the first thing she sees?
The first thing you see is Scanlan holding you. You're now outside of the temple, the entire Young Viril city around you. You look forward, and on your shoulders clutching you is Scanlan, blood streaking down the front of his face, the big smile.
Scanlan, are you hurt?
I'm fine, baby. How are you?
I'm great. Well, not really. I'll give Scanlan a kiss on his cheek.
Okay.
Oh, do I get inspiration for that?
You do. D6 inspiration.
I'm never gonna watch it again.
It's this strangely romantic moment. She reaches forward, grabs him, kisses him in the cheek, and pulls away. And he looks at her with this beautiful smile. And then the sound effects kick in again of like the bat screeching ahead and of all the elephants swarming up the side of the temple.
Is that big scaffolding still hanging over it? I'm feeling handsy. Baby's hand!
A weird bit of bent metal that was once part of the mostly destroyed structure that held it aloft in the center of the temple wrenches forth and snaps as the entire structure begins to be pulled at an angle.
Yes!
It's Bigby's hand!
It slams down at an angle into the side of the brain and then coming to rest on top, crushing even further the corpse of Clarota.
Yeah.
So the structure slams into the elder brain, and see now it's taking some real damage. Immediately, the two mind flayers that were floating up look down, freaked out, and begin moving towards the brain now instinctively to defend it.
And bonus action, can I pour some superior healing potion down Pike's beautiful throat?
You can. Yeah.
No.
I'm just pouring my potion down Pike's throat.
Anyway.
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna turn into a huge pterodactyl and carry some folks.
Okay.
What?
You can do that.
Sure. Why not? Up and away.
Okay. At the top of the round.
Trinket is like the dumbest.
Don't talk about Trinket like that.
Water channel that's between the north side of the island and the beach where you guys previously set. You. So who else goes there? Who else? Please step outside. Prepare yourselves.
Hi.
Hello. You look particularly perky today.
Well, I've had a rather good day, I could say.
I was wondering if I could inquire about a specific kind of scrying potion that I would like. Made for me. It's a specialty item. I don't know if any exist.
Well, please do step into my office.
Oh, what is that? Patchouli, I smell?
Quite an astute nose you have.
When we get excited, I, well, never mind that. Anyway, I'm looking for a way, a potion that I can maybe drink or use to help me sort of, look in on a place that we've been to recently. I could maybe leave a mark of some sort, and then use that mark to magically scry into that place.
You see, like a light bulb go off in his eyes. He goes,
Curious. You're into some things.
So Scanlan comes down into your workshop underneath Grayskull Keep. You hear a fine little ditty to inspire you in your work.
Whoa! I hear you're tinkering. Whoa! Please do it well. Take my hand and you'll tinker, I swear. Whoa!
Please do it well.
Tinkering on a prayer!
There we go.
Okay. Now I feel inspired.
I was about to give you a D6, but that'll be the full D10.
Can I jump up? I jump up on a table and I say, listen, you motherfuckers! My friend just asked you a fucking question, now fucking answer him, or I'm gonna kill every last motherfucker one of you!
I'd listen to him. He means it.
Come on,
Scanlan.
Yeah, please be good. Come on, Scanlan.
That would be a 30.
Oh, good life!
Oh, wait, no.
Amazing!
Yes, 28. I added wrong. Right. 28.
Oh, well, that makes the difference. So, in an unseen display, the Goliath storms into the bar and makes no impact, yet the tiniest gnome jumps onto the table like a ravenous wolverine, frothing at the mouth, his wild eyes staring about the dark interior of the Laughing Lamia. All the patrons at the table around him, you can see,
lean back in fear. Caught off guard by this entirely, one man holding a drink just drops it and hear it shatter on the ground.
The small band playing in the far corner, you hear like, discordant sound as all instruments break to a halt. The dancer stops, the whole room is dead silent.
No.
Thank you for your forthrightness and honesty.
What kind of potion did you get?
All right.
It's a potion that, when combined with, when consumed, can allow me to leave a mark of some sort that possibly I could use to have visions of what is in the area. Mechanics of which I would not like to get into at this moment.
It was a curious endeavor, but I think you'll be happy with the results.
So we can spy.
Any chance to talk to you, Gilmore, leaves me happy beyond compare.
Oh, stop it. Flattery will get you everywhere.
Did you get that potion so you can spy on Pike when she's naked?
I am offended and terrified at the assumption that I would sink so low as to spy on my good friend and future wife, Pike. When her pantaloons are down.
You laugh a little harder.
Not at all. How dare you? How dare you?
Yeah.
Have I ever spied
yes.
on a member of our current party?
Yes, you have.
No. A current party?
No.
Yes.
Okay. I'll cast Bigby's hand. You know it. Shaman. on the griffin?
This gargantuan version of a Scanlan fist comes rocketing through the sky, the fingers unraveling, clutching the griffin. Its rider, who is holding on to the reins at the front, is now dangling and going to attempt to try and hold on. And rolls a 3.
Yeah! I'm also going to inspire Vex with just for her archery skills. Just a little.
Go for it.
Okay. Elvish people in the ship tonight. Everybody just have a good fight.
It starts preparing itself to do a series of attacks, and your big hand just blindsides it, sending it over the edge of the railing. So, as it's clamping down on you, its tail whips in the air.
And you miss me like the deserts miss the rain.
The wyvern, who is still clamped down on your body, its one eye opens up and goes, you hear an audible Sam has joined us. And that's where we pick up and begin.
Can you say all of that again for me?
You don't listen anyway.
The ironstone, which you take and kind of place by your head and release, it seems to almost affix itself in the air and slowly rotate above your head, almost like held in its own orbital gravity around you.
Pike! Check this out!
It is fancy.
It's like a halo. Like your god has smiled on me, maybe, and said, he's cool, go for it.
Oh, wow. Well, I don't know if that's what it means.
Well, you know, religion is up to interpretation, so I interpret it that way.
It is very, very cool looking.
Thank you.
Saren Ray, the sheep bro you never had.
Saren Ray is my wingman.
You start seeing what looks like specks of white snow begin to drift from the clouds ahead.
It's
I'm dreaming of a white, whatever we celebrate.
So you guys,
there was... my fancy cloak room, wear that, right?
Huge on you.
So I won't wear one.
I give you one.
I'll gird it.
We'll say you could probably like put it over. Okay, yeah. It'll just look a little bit chunky.
Okay. I'm gonna take a large fancy robe and try to tie it up to gird it so that it looks.
He wants a fancy robe, okay. Not
be
a.
Be aware,
I'm gird my loins.
And you gird them well. Okay. You're like the tiniest Turkish wrestler you've ever seen. It's kind of adorable.
I'm Pike.
Keyleth.
I'm Ion Stone Bearer Scanlan.
Cocks his head curiously.
You can call me Kingslayer. I also did that.
Very well.
Great. Good job, Jon.
Thanks, Jon.
You hear no response.
Why does he still work here?
Very good question.
Did you like tenure to his or something? Is it a union thing?
He's been with us for many, many years.
Haggled with the Pope. Watcher
inquiring.
Shaking down the
Pope. Religion's a choice.
Is a monetary reward. 3,000 gold pieces.
Per party member, yes?
Entirely.
Take money from the church. We don't want money, of course not. I mean, I.
But think of the good we could do with that money, giving alms to the poor back home where we are.
Yes.
We do a lot of charity work, and it would be well received back home in the keep.
You make a persuasion roll. You make a deception roll.
Deception.
What'd you roll, Sam?
A 30.
3-0?
3-0. I have a plus 13 for deception.
Oh, that explains so much.
We gotta get you deceiving more.
3,000 gold at your disposal to bring about to share in the prosperity of your people back home.
Amen.
Once the artifact is delivered and sealed.
From one holy man to another, I think we've struck a deal. Let's go.
Bert Reynolds, you've done it again.
As you all turn, Kimmy goes, I'll show you to the vault. Excellent. That's over at you. Shall we? Holy man.
Why, yes, my sister, lead the way.
She's been with us the whole time, don't forget that guy.
As you guys are walking out of the chamber, the door is closed behind, he turns to you and says, is that why you were blessed with such a temporarily swollen appendage before?
I don't know how the Lord works, it's mysterious. Ooh, shut up, and shoot that hole. Oh. Your arrow is my destiny. And I said, ooh, ooh, shut up and shoot that hole.
Circumstance, you make your way.
Dun, dun, dun,
one
dun,
fails.
It's this one. Music. That's me.
Fails. All right, so these two take damage. Go ahead and roll it.
Okay, so I take 2d12.
I've never rolled a double-digit initiative roll ever.
Oh, scan it.
I'm ready to make my attack turn.
All right. There is nothing there.
I sheath my soul.
There you go. As you stealthily move along the side of the wall, Scanlan comes pattering down the stonework.
18.
Scanlan, no!
Scanlan will not physically wait for you, but emotionally, I will wait for you. And I will not stray emotionally. I will always be there for you, emotionally.
Okay, Scanlan. But
physically, I mean, come on. It's going to be months.
Hey! Hey! I got Scanlan with me.
Like a trailing fart.
Like a trailing fart.
That couldn't have worked out better.
What?
Ass hole?
You like this?
Where you, what does it say? Where you what?
Is that ash hole
or ash
pole?
It's
the ass pole.
The ass pole.
Ass pole.
It's just a bar that I like to go to.
Yeah, sure it is.
The ass pole. Scanlan is feeling still just terribly sad about leaving Pike, so overcome with emotion that he must step into the ruins just one last time. And before I do so, I drink one of my potions. I want to see where she's going to be, so I know she's safe. I shed a single tear.
You feel a rumbling in your stomach.
I feel uncomfortable. It must be the emotion.
It's probably the emotion.
I find a sort of a side chamber or just a little nook.
And there is a small alcove not far from there within the earth wall, and it does have a view of the current ruin.
I say a little prayer, and I take a big dump on the floor.
No, you do not!
Well, my stomach was rumbling.
Oh,
the Temple of Serenry.
Well, I... Pike's probably gonna have to be the one to clean that up.
Sometimes it just affects me. I have weak nerves.
No.
Are you invisible?
How do I say goodbye to what we almost had?
This is not romantic at all. You know.
Welcome back, guys. Sorry. The remnants of what you leave behind have a very soft blue glowing hue to them.
You have magic poop?
I
so
left
you
a magic
shed
dump.
A diamond.
Do we need or to collect the dump?
Nope, we should leave the dump.
Are you going to be able to like see through the dump?
He's covering his face. I think we need the blue. I think we need
the blue
shit.
Can you cast detect magic on the poo?
Oh, are
it's
we there?
It's already magical
no,
poo.
No, we're not
are
there.
Are we there? We're not
we're
there.
We're not there. It's we're just Scanlan.
So, he's just shitting.
He's just leaving it.
So I leave and rejoin my fellows, wiping the tear from my eye and the poo from my bottom. So I took a potion that will let me see through my poo.
Okay.
And be able to check in on Pike from time to time. I ordered a potion from.
Will she realize that you can see her through the poo?
I certainly hope not. I certainly hope not. It's magic poo!
Don't change, Scanlan.
100 of my own gold on me.
I'll bet 50 gold against him. We have to hedge. We have to hedge.
We have to hedge. We have to hedge.
100 gold is the minimum.
Well, then I can't afford it. I'm sorry. Gotta quickly take out my potion of fire giant strength, and I just sort of slip it to him before he takes a drink of his ale. I don't know if I hand it to him.
Make a stealth check.
Okay.
A hand grasps your wrist.
Ow!
I'm watching you.
It's...
One more try and I'm throwing you in there. We'll go down ourselves.
It's for my asthma. Philip, Philip, do that thing where you move your pecs up and down.
He just runs up and soccer ball kicks you in the side of your ribs. Just whack!
From the stands, I turn to a portly gentleman next to me and I say,
Sir, do you see what that fucking little elf said about your mother? He called her a name I can't even repeat. I'm so sorry.
Well, deal with him after the fight. You got too much money on this right
now. What an asshole.
With a resounding crack, Grog's head spins, his body turning. He stumbles a couple of steps, falls to one knee.
No!
Face down in the dirt, unconscious. That was so close.
That was unfortunate. I go down and nurse him, nurse his head, hold him, and I just tell him, Grog, you won. You did it, buddy.
Make a deception roll.
Oh my god.
16?
I would say, given the circumstances, it's nice that he's trying. Aww. But it's been a while since you've invested in one-on-one combat.
I'll be at the bar.
Okay.
Oh, Grog, come on.
As you take
that's it, not even chicken, that's just a piece of wood.
And yet it doesn't stop him as he, bite by bite, makes his way through the piece of driftwood he found by the bar.
Just put a little salt on it.
Which the bar stools, by the way, have kind of a thick, crusty wool on them. So there's a unique flavor to the piece you've chewed through.
Frying on this chicken is exquisite.
Oh, I can guarantee you, a beast of that size, not much of a problem's got a hell of a price on its head.
From who?
Wow. And the ranger's gonna range, and the tracker's gonna track. I'm just gonna watch her range.
Watch her range. Woo-hoo! In this area, because of the nature of the rich earth, most of the foliage here is in deep green.
I'm going to turn us all deep green. With seeming.
With
what now?
Seeming.
Thank you. Yes.
Got it.
With seeming. I spread my seeming all over us, turning us green with seeming all over us.
Oh, man. Okay.
Nothing you can't ruin.
Does not make it safe.
With 11 points of poison damage to its head, that's just the first attack that hits. And then I take my keen dagger and I jab for...
Punch it. That's it.
Good.
Punch.
All right.
That's my move. Punch.
All right.
It's Bigby's hand. Bigby's hand. You know it. Shamona. And the whole world is
right.
Bigby's hand.
Go ahead and roll a d20 and add your spell attack. Yeah. You actually punch one of the heads off the hydra. It goes spinning off into the...
Oh, no. Oh,
no.
No, we don't want to punch heads off.
Hey guys, I got rid of another head! Hey guys, I'm on a roll!
Oh no!
I'm gonna inspire Grog with my bonus action.
Alright, what are you inspiring with?
Candy.
Oh, I gotta inspire with. Oh, come on, Grog! Yeah, you know what I mean! It is time to rage on this Hydra! There's an insignia that we get. Is it a. Given to us on some sort of jacket for members only? Could it be?
She reaches to part of her shoulder pulcher and lifts it up, and you can see there's a brand in the side of her arm.
Ooh.
Oh.
I love that. My body's a temple. I don't like that.
Then perhaps you would like to judge.
Do I have to get branded?
It does not hurt much.
I'm really wimpy. Yes, do you mind an henna?
I would take that as an acceptance on your part as well.
Thank you.
Enough.
Yes, I'm with my group.
Who's your favorite character on the show?
Hello.
Not the one with the scatological problem.
I think of it more as a gift. That keeps giving.
Boom! Clap the sound of your gun. The beat goes on and on and on and on.
Zara.
What?
Zara Hydrus. And what's yours?
Me?
Yes.
Well, I'm known by different names in different places.
Ain't that the truth?
Really?
Some call me Kingslayer.
Some call me Scanlan. Some just call me when they want a good time.
Mostly we just call him Scanlan.
I'll keep the good time in mind.
All right. I volunteer to be leader of the group.
That is not up for discussion. I am sorry, small man. Which could be my halfling.
I actually make a cup of beer.
A rather large, visibly bulging pouch to her side.
She's got a Scrooge McDuck bag?
Seemingly.
I could save a little if I shared a horse with you.
Oh. What? No, I'd rather have my own horse. Thank you. Thank you.
You can ride with me, Scanlan.
Nothing.
But, Trinket. does Trinket. Is he.
Shut down.
Is he.
No, I don't want to get hurt by you.
Alright, go ahead and roll the d10 to reduce.
Where does it come from?
Is it 10? Okay, so I reduced that by 2.
22.
Yeah, so he's still hit.
Yeah.
But he got a song out of it.
Lucky bastard.
Managed to just pull out of the way so that it hits the armor and deflects, but it leaves a huge gash in the front of the armor. That'll bring us to Grog. Thankfully, he's not used to attacking things so small and duck quickly out of the way.
Fuck you! I raise my hand to Lyra and say that you could use some Scanlan today. Tonight I give you a detail.
You're not doing
that. Wow, that worked.
Wow, that was amazing.
That was amazing.
I turn around and sort of barf because I just saw a guy's upper half get incinerated.
You listen to me so good. It's like my besties.
I feel a connection, I do. You know, when you were telling me about
Aldor... It's not sexual at all. I'm not attracted to you. Like, literally, if it happened, I would be ill. But it's really true.
Believe me. You repulse me.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, really.
Oh my God, I'm so with you right there. Oh, but yeah. Really, as a friend, you are so nice. I feel like I'm worth your dishes.
I've had some Aldors in my life, too.
I want to hear all about them.
Yes. Mainly they were whores who kicked me out early.
He was very attracted to me that night, and we had intercourse, so...
Somehow you made that less sexual than I could have ever imagined. Is there a... What's the term for when your penis is inverted? It's the opposite of a boner?
Belly button.
Yeah, that's what I've got now.
Add those numbers
six.
Up.
Okay. Six. Six.
Well, don't say that.
Dominate monster.
Humanoid? They're not humanoid?
They are not. They are considered giants. They are a different species. You would know that.
I would know that. Well, then I guess I won't do that. Okay. 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 Well, then.
It's a very short show tonight.
Yeah. Okay, well, then we just die. I would like to inspire our new fellow Zara with a little quick ditty. Ooh, you so scary. Ooh, you so scary. Ooh, you so scary. You fighty long time. Can I kind of snuggle between his legs and maybe he'll forget I'm there?
He's hung like a horse.
Can I hit yourself in the head?
He would swing.
Swing on it, man. Swing on it.
Yes. Yes, Kevin.
Do you want to try this?
It might anger him.
Probably. Or it might weaken him.
Or it might entice him.
Insulting, insufferable insect into the heart of my domain.
I'm called Burt Reynolds, and I take great offense at that.
The dragon's head turns to the side for a moment with a glance of confusion and almost amusement that you speak up to it with such a disrespectful manner.
You can call me Mr. Reynolds or simply Bert.
And its head looks down upon you directly.
Bert.
And Hunter's Mark on it.
19, I know.
My eyes begin to change to a dark shade.
Yes!
As I turn my gaze to the dragon and cast Eyebite on him.
What? You cast what?
I would like to sicken him. Give him a little tummy ache. And give some inspiration to Lyra. I'll say, when the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's Aldore.
Oh! Yeah, going deep.
I'll do, it's Bigby's hand, Shamanai. I'll just punch him in his dragon face.
Okay.
Yes!
Straight up Popeye punching towards the dragon.
No, he won't. I cast a spell on it as it retreats from me.
Okay.
Because I am a warcaster.
Okay.
And I will cast Bigby's hand to grapple that shit and pull him back down.
That's right, do the warcaster beat. Okay.
So, don't you fly away from me, motherfucker!
I'm
so hot for you right now.
As the dragon brings his wings up, whoosh, whoosh. The hand
stay.
Grabs its wings together and forces it back onto the ground. It shakes off the effect, but it's unable to fly
you
away.
You leave when Burt Reynolds tells you to leave.
It's going to make all of them against you.
Of course it will. And thus ends Scanlan.
No.
We'll make each attack as it goes. So the first attack against you is going to be the bite at 18 points of piercing damage.
Oh no, Scanlan's unconscious!
Are you unconscious?
Yeah.
Okay, it's already all in. Its second claw attack hits, you immediately fail a death saving throw from the second strike. Second claw attack hits you as well as it's focused on you. You failed two death saving
throws.
Oh my god!
What? Oh my gosh!
It's a dragon!
Oh my god.
That's the end of its turn. Bro, you're up.
I race over to Scanlan and I pour a level 3 healing potion into Scanlan's mouth.
This is the superior one?
Yeah.
You heal 8d4 plus 8.
And I roll 4d8s?
8d4. You have a better chance.
This is my friend, the lady favors. I need him. And I won't throw. I'll slide him on the icy floor towards Lyra.
Okay. Go ahead. Make an athletics check.
Okay.
Hockey.
Natural 20.
Yes! Ow. I run over to Lyra, cast Seeming on myself to give myself the appearance of Aldor. And I pour a potion into her mouth, and I wake her up.
Oh, what happened?
You did good, baby.
I'm just in him. Then I notice, Aldor, why are you so short?
Baby,
I'm out of here.
I can't change height, so. So I release Seeming and I'm back to normal.
That was not as good a kiss as usual. I was worried.
I'm sorry.
But it was special.
Oh!
With inspiration.
Okay. I inspire them.
She inspires Zara as she goes to start carving into this dragon.
I will sing something. I don't know what. I'm so out of it. We just killed a dragon. I just go over to her and I'm like, you killed a dragon.
Oh no. We got Scanlan jumping ship now.
I've never been over here. Everything flushes the other way around.
Yeah, that's how it works in this place. Yeah.
Hello.
Oh,
Scanlan.
Hello, Scanlan.
Where have you guys been?
Scanlan, you just around?
What? Pike? Wait,
really
what?
I said that really
quickly.
First thing.
That was a bit harsh, wasn't it?
We took a field trip with her. You were.
What are you talking about? Why didn't you call me? We have an earring!
You left your earring.
We have an earring! You didn't lead with Pike, though. You should have said, Pike's here. Hey, Pike's here.
You probably should have done that.
My bad.
Sorry about that. I mean, I was having a fun time, but I would have dropped everything to be with Pike. Pike first. Always Pike first.
Right, sorry.
Pike first.
I wasn't even in a brothel.
I was.
Oh, you were.
I walked toward the brothel.
but then I bumped into Zara, remember?
Zara?
Oh,
yeah. Yes.
Zara.
She invited me over, we talked all night, one thing led to another. Nothing untoward, but we just had a nice slumber party. It was lovely. It was me and a couple of tieflings. Three, I think. We were doing each other's hair, telling stories, playing songs. It was wonderful.
Can I roll to see if he's bullshitting?
You are enthralled by his tale. Your elbows are on the edge of the bedspread right now. Your hands clasped.
My feet behind me crisscrossing, yeah, like kicking.
Oh, you're this close to like a breakdown from Greece. It's pretty fantastic.
Tell me more! Tell me more! It was great. We had a great PG night. Except I would have dropped everything to come to see the woman I love, but the woman of my dreams, the woman I will marry and bear children with.
Yes.
Wow. Wow.
That got really
I don't know
real.
If she'll bear mine or I'll bear hers.
I've never heard you say that out loud.
Yes, how does
I
it work with gnomes?
Very impressive.
Gnomes, it's tricky.
Yes, I've never seen a gnome birth.
But at least we're all together again.
We got to meet my family.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
I missed everything.
We missed a couple of points, but
what did you do for all the days we've been gone now?
This was a long slumber party.
Did you do nails and?
We did. Not my hands. Just my toenails.
Oh, good.
All right. We braided hair. We connected.
That's wonderful.
Sounds nice.
Connected.
Well, at least we're all back. We can get on the flying carpet and go somewhere fun, right?
Oh. Well.
Oh.
What?
Oh. Yeah.
Oh.
Oh.
Subtly say, I'd like 100 against Grog, please.
Okay. He looks down at you and says,
not bad. Going with the odds.
I'll collect later. Don't say it.
I'll tap out.
You got this, Grog. Yeah, you got this.
Yeah. Good child.
Grog! 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 Grog!
As they're chanting, I'm starting to sing amid the chant. It's the eye of the Goliath, it's the thrill of the fight, rising up to the challenge of that asshole. And I'm trying to send inspiration to him.
With that, you hear through the fury, through the anger, that the chant, your real name, not Philip now, your real name.
Right.
And through all that, you hear the gentle hymn. Scanlan's voice cut through all that and come to you with a beat, a rhythmic beat that drives you forward. Go ahead and take a D10 inspiration. You feel yourself pulled off balance and the momentum pulling you towards him as he unleashes another flurry of blows.
As he does, I shout out from the audience using my cutting words.
What do you shout?
Oh, Kern! Do you need some dick? Cause I gave some to your mom last night.
Go ahead and roll a d10 and I'll distract you from this attack.
D10?
Yeah, roll a d10 and...
That was a burn! That was a burn!
Fuck, only three!
That's
okay. So his roll was a 21, that brings it down to an 18. What's your armor class?
It's 18.
18, so it still hits. Still, that was awesome.
So I was going to sing to him to inspire. I guess I can still try.
Yeah, go for it. What do you want to sing?
With your arms and your fists and your legs and your wrists, it's in your head, in your head, you are fighting. That's all I got.
D10 inspiration die to you, Grog, in this pinnacle moment. So hold on to that D10.
Okay. 17.
Plus 10! Plus 10!
22!
22. Roll damage.
Come on.
8!
How do you want to do this? R.I.P. your ears, everyone.
Sorry.
Clutch Scanlan inspiration. Grog, how do you want to do this?
What's the fine? How much is the fine?
Who are you?
Oh, hi.
He's my lawyer.
I'm Burt Reynolds, Esquire.
Right.
I'm an attorney at large. I represent all manner of...
An attorney at small.
Escaped mental patients.
I mean, he's a gnome.
Mega deception check.
The mustache is up. 20.
Well, very well.
Small Reynolds, sir.
If you would like us to fill out, if you would like us to fill out paperwork, I have about two reams of paperwork for you to fill out to release them to us as well. And also, there will be court costs involved.
Oh boy!
And triplicate, you'll have to get your supervisor to fill out this one, and I will need this one, and I will need this one as well.
500 gold, fine, and we'll release them to you. All right? Is that fine?
That's fine. And they'll still get to collect their winnings from the pit?
I don't care what they're going to do. Just take them from me. It's good. If I see either of you two causing any trouble anywhere in Vasselheim, it's down to the oubliette you go. You hear me?
Say that word again. What? Oubliette?
The amaranthine oubliette. What is wrong with me? Get out of here! Run!
You've been bested!
You've out-talked the talker as the guard finds himself so flustered by the frustration and anger that he's been caused by this entire strange arrival of individuals.
Oh, no.
His speech pattern has been muddled, and in frustration shoves both of you out the front door and slams it behind you.
As I leave, he's speaking Dragonian!
I think he's having an aneurysm. Listen, I would show any part of me for, like, 2 gold.
I know.
Here's 2 gold.
Oh, here. Take a look at my third nipple.
On your thigh?
It was cute. It can be wherever I put it, really. It's magical. I'm feeling a little bit pike sick right now. I could concentrate very hard.
Just concentrate for a moment and see what she's doing. Tell us what you see. Unless she's naked, in which case stop looking.
Of course, I would definitely stop looking if I saw her naked in front of my poo.
Oh, God.
Definitely.
Okay. You sit down and close your eyes and begin to concentrate.
Is this the first?
Yeah.
Okay.
And as you begin to focus your energy, the sense of the arcane mind itself is gathered between the center of the head and the center of the chest. You begin to join these in the center, and your consciousness begins to glide downward towards your bowels. Gnome figure that is currently kind of acting as foreman for this whole construction process.
What'd you see?
She was definitely naked.
Really?
No, she was supervising her crew in a fair but firm way. And she was just being pike-driven, radiant, beautiful, and powered by the spirit of Saren Rae. She's everything that we think of her and more. She's beautiful and charming. And Pike was glorious and wonderful and confident, and I miss her so much, and I hope from time to time I can look in on her.
I've never had to say this out loud before. I've never actually had this discussion with anyone.
It's okay. It gets better.
Do I get an inspiration die for that?
I'll give you a D6 inspiration.
Lord and Lady Briarwood are responsible for the death of my entire family.
Oh. And if we kill them, how much will you pay us? Just kidding. Just kidding. Just kidding. We ask other people that, but not me.
You.
We could go into town and find you a bushy mustache. It's worked for me many times.
I don't think I wear one as well as you do.
I should put these in the lost and found.
Sherry!
If I may. What Keyleth was trying to say was that she never got a chance to go to college, and that she wanted to feel like she wanted to get that university experience.
Oh,
university.
Good luck.
You're a woman of the world, and I'm sure you have fine taste, judging by your appearance. It is quite fine, if I may say so myself. If I were a little taller, I would probably ask you out on a date.
If you were a little taller, yes.
Sherry is sassy today.
And one other thing. You know those books that my friend was asking about? Could we maybe make those happen for her? I know that you had quoted her a low, low price of 25. I'd be prepared to pay even more than that for them. And compose you a little song about yourself.
At which point, for the first time since the entire time you've been in the shop of Gilmore's Glorious Goods, you see a slight grin creep across her lips.
How could a lady say no to a song?
25 gold, the price tag.
I bring out my something. Sherry, baby.
Sherry, baby, Sherry, won't you come home tonight?
Come home tonight.
Come home tonight. You better ask your mama. Tell her you're with a gnome.
Bo, 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 bo. Why don't you come on
to my keys?
Pay for the book, I hear you.
I kind of druid craft a flower real quick and slip it to Scanlan to give to her.
Here you are.
Thank you.
Do you want to build a machine gun?
Why, yes, I really do.
I assume I sit at the kiddie table because I'm so tiny.
They've got a booster chair for you.
Oh, good.
They do have adjustments for gnomish guests.
It's a fun
way of putting it. All right. After you guys sit for a few moments.
Please, if we might rise for our guests, Lord and Lady Briarwood, to join us at the table.
I am risen already. I'm standing already.
Bring in the gnome!
Do you desire a gnome, sire?
I would like the gnome brought before me.
Bring the king a gnome, make sure he is of foul mouth in many a song.
Oh, fetching the gnome!
Yay!
Yay!
Yay! Yeah, buddy! You made it.
Okay, I'd like to plug a few things.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
However, we do have a present for you.
We do.
Because there have been periods of time which you've complained about not having a proper stein or mug to match the rest of the group, we figure.
Got a Google one.
Google one works fine.
It's fine.
But thanks to some of our wondrous, illustrious campmates, we were with the Burning Man. They gifted this unto us to gift unto you, as we felt it was fitting and size appropriate.
Proportionally accurate.
Oh, yes!
It's as big as you are!
It makes me look cute!
You have to hold it two
How
hands.
Like Scanlan has hold it.
You have to measure that out in a regular cup first and then pour it in.
Yeah.
You could pour two whole drinks in there and it would just be like,
look like nothing.
A half an inch of liquid.
Yeah, you gotta get it pressed first.
This thing's amazing!
So thanks, post-nuclear family.
Well done.
Thank you.
You're awesome.
It's amazing.
Wow! It's like a hotel ice thing.
Yeah, it's technically an ice
bucket.
Oh,
yeah,
man,
but
I
want to like
fill it up right now.
No, it's up.
Thank you, guys.
You're welcome.
Of Percy, we're coming to court within a week to have a feast and talk with Sovereign Uriel Tal'Dorei. And what are you doing?
Lock it up.
I mean, I pour a whole glass in there and it looks like nothing.
Good. You just gotta keep pouring. Such a high esteem.
Oh, that back. Back a bit by vampires. And his skin's turning pale and white. But don't worry, he's around the corner.
What's going on?
Here comes Scanlan, everything's gonna be alright.
I feel like I'm going insane!
And I sing to Lady Delilah. Hey there, Delilah, won't you listen to me, cause I'm about to cast a spell on you. Ooh, ooh. Oh! As I see this going 13. On, can I call out with cutting words to distract him?
You could, yes.
Okay. Destruction! Destruction! Feedle, deedle, diddle, deedle, destruction!
The fingers are coming towards you, and you try and bend to roll all the way. All of a sudden, you hear destruction! And Bo's. You see like eye roll, and then goes in for the attack, but that's giving you enough time to kind of roll out of the way, and his hand only meets the ground.
Yes.
Nice!
You're now there, face to face. You are essentially the shield of the group right now between the Briarwoods.
Hello! What a lovely dinner! We had lightning! And I will inspire Keyleth. Can you feel the blood tonight?
I'd like to use Phantasmal Killer.
What is that?
It's Lord Briarwood again.
All right.
That sounds awesome.
Her accent is so fake.
I know, right?
So.
And why did you infiltrate the castle?
Infiltrate? I like that.
That's how the British people say it.
Oh, really?
Yes, well. Aluminium.
Well.
I'll just take a step towards her and I will try. It's never worked for me. It probably won't work. Yeah, I'll try eye bite on her.
This is the time.
I'm doing it through my horn of clarity. Whatever.
No, it does not make it.
Okay.
So what are you choosing?
I choose sleep.
Nice. Okay. So,
goodbye, old lady.
Comes around, she's holding this kind of gnarled wand in her hand. As she comes around, she gives you the strange look.
Sleep.
Yes!
Yes!
Unconscious on the ground, sleeping.
Awesome.
And then I will just inspire our new tiefling friend with just kind of a little sexy dance.
Right. What are you doing?
Just fall asleep again. Old hand. Back to sleep.
Nope.
Yes!
Falls asleep on the ground with an arrow right out of the back.
She's an evil mercenary. Oh. She deserves to be taken out.
But she's such
I
a
was fun. Just oh, trying to that, find
there's
my
there, yeah. He hasn't taken any damage, has he?
Brain.
I've right. fallen and I can't get out.
Shit on his face.
Disgusting.
Listen, it's not just something I can do whenever.
Who are you kidding?
I have to be in the mood.
That's the grossest thing
I need
heard.
Some music, some nice lighting. I need to be wined and dined.
Perhaps I will drown.
And he turns and starts just walking towards the shoreline on the other side to the west of the
Yes.
Oh, you Percy had a...
Percy was upset.
Maybe he needed some comforting.
We should totally check on him.
Okay, but if there's a sock or a gun on the doorknob, don't
go in.
Don't
go in. Right. Be great. Yeah. I tell everyone that she's gone. Oh. Gone.
No. She's gone. In Percy's room. Scanlan, let's go see if he's banging.
All right, let's go.
The door is already partially ajar.
Boom!
Where is she?
Wham! Thank you!
So-and-so.
This room is left in far more disarray than you're used to seeing true to Percy's character.
My God, Grog. Percy's a hoarder.
Right.
Or he's in serious distress.
I think it's the previous.
The hoarder?
Yeah, probably.
We must find him, don't you think? Our friend's in trouble. I proceed down to his tinkering lab.
The workshop door is currently closed. There's a small kind of slider, kind of eye vent where you can kind of peek through.
Can I reach the eye vent?
You can if you leap hard enough and catch it on the edge.
I boost him up.
Okay. Looking inside, you can see the forge is aglow.
Please, leave me be. I have a lot to think about right now.
Would you like a meal brought down?
I'm fine. Thank you, really. I need some time.
All right, if you're making things, a little ladder for the little perch here might be nice, just in the future, but not now. That seems low priority.
He stops his banging, walks over and scribbles something on a paper, and goes back banging. Noted. Ting.
He chainsawed her, a sleeping, unconscious woman. You also kind of were the only other one who seemed to be kind of confused as to what was going on.
Right. I made her go to sleep. That was peaceful.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm a nice
that was
guy.
Good.
Are you taking moral exception to some of our behavior?
That might exactly be what I'm saying. Man, this is why I like you, Scanlan. You're so much better at the words than me. Maybe we shouldn't dissect a woman with a spinning kroll blade.
This is constructive criticism, and we'll take it as such. And I, for one, will maybe not desecrate and denigrate bodies.
Just beds and temples.
Beds are fair game.
I don't know. I mean, I see what Keyleth's saying, but I don't really want to cramp your style, Scanlan.
Yeah, I promise you'll keep shitting on things.
Oh, I'll shit on
please.
Things. I mean, maybe not people.
Please.
We're like...
So you first cast.
Om Mani Padme Hum, Om Mani Padme Hum, Om Mani Padme Hum.
All right, so first you cast Enhance Ability on yourself, you say?
Am I maybe inspired by that?
Sure. Sure, in the tension of the room, the slow droning hum of the gnome, which you can notice, some of the guards kind of look at each other, confused, and assume it's this hand of like, hold on.
Objection.
That's it. I just wanted to say that. It's. Please continue. I just want it noted that we object strongly to this.
There is the sigil that it sends to, and there is the actual the ritual circle that is created. The circle that attaches to it is not the same as the destination. There are elements of it that connect it.
Okay. Thanks for the cups, guys. The cups. Yeah. I just noticed that.
There's some simple clothes, weathered skin, and as you call out to them, they both smile. You can see deep set smile lines
in
their faces.
We hate old people. Totally.
Who are you?
Favorite enemy.
You're also kind of the key to our own freedom, so it's kind of important.
You also caught us on a day where we were trying to be nicer to people. Lucky for you. You think you can take Percy?
Well, I think at least I can talk some sense into him.
I like him.
Just out of curiosity, if he was running at you, what would you do? Something very cool.
Well, first and foremost, I would dive in the forward motion, leg out, to put him off balance. This is beef from a frontal melee. You're messing with me, aren't you?
A little bit.
Gnomes.
All right. Well, keep him safe, and there's an extra 5 gold in it for you. Ten gold.
Gnomes.
I don't know how money works. Well, I'll talk to Max about it.
Certainly. All right. I will.
Before you leave, I'm sorry. I have an itch. And it can only be scratched with a cowbell. Do you have a cowbell anywhere around
here? Wait, do you need more cowbell?
I just need a cowbell.
More.
It will.
And cowbell.
And can I borrow a cowbell from you?
Your kid's weird.
And he keeps walking.
Your kid is weird.
Tell people about Vox
Machina. Not a child.
Same dude.
I bet there's one out there.
Do I see any cowbells on the ground?
And you can take a glance about. You eventually can see that there is set up on one of the... One of the fences that fences in the cows, there is a cowbell, yes.
Hey, there's a cowbell.
Great. It will help the ruse. Here's my plan.
Okay.
We're all cows. Is that an okay plan?
I like it. Yeah. I'm kind of into this plan.
All right, I guess.
But doesn't that essentially make us the bait?
Yes, we're our own bait. Are you cool with that?
Totally. Come on, unless it kills him instantly, we'll be fine.
I'm going to lay in wait with an arrow, just, you know.
Pepper time,
all
baby.
The rest bovine
creature. Pepper time.
I think I'm better served waiting to strike once.
Oh, you!
No, because you're up close.
You and me,
Grog. You're up close, guys.
We're cows.
Yes,
if
baby.
If he grabs one of them, I will.
I can turn us all into a cow. Well, polymorph is a concentration spell.
I can turn us all into cows.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because you got that thing.
Yes, I'll be fine.
Cow or no, Keyleth? Give thing. Us your answer.
Oh, I'm a cow.
What thing?
Seeming.
Oh, we're not actually cows.
Oh my god. We'll just seem like cows.
Well then yes, we'll all be cows.
We're all cows. Just embrace it.
Can't change a target's body type.
What? Oh. No.
So same form of limbs. You're right. So
you can't change size, but we can all be like grog sized cows or Scanlan size.
It's gonna be an array,
look like
a very
array of different cows.
Rangely sized cows.
Super juicy cows.
Scanlan, why don't you be like a calf? Baby cow.
What do you think?
Yeah. Does he want veal?
Like
or
it.
Does he
I'll
want
allow it.
If I may, I'm going to wear the cowbell.
Sure. You've earned it.
If I may.
Just, it's camouflage.
Oh,
you take the guess.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's good.
Thank you.
That's good.
Yeah.
This is why.
Let's be cows.
I have to give you experience for that.
Oh wait, no.
You, by the way, you're more of a calf.
Oh, you're like so cute, Scandal. Okay, shall we go interview some cows?
Yeah, let's go talk to some cows.
The goat goes, the cow goes.
I want to walk over to the cows with you.
You guys step up awkwardly towards the cows.
Because nothing is happening, I am now trying to eat grass.
I for once, and it's not weird, I just shit on the floor. Seems totally normal.
We are in it, baby.
Okay, a dimension door.
What's the range of dimension door?
500 feet.
You and appear where? Where do you want to appear?
On it. On its back.
Okay.
You
appear right on its back.
Stay with it!
You immediately like land and start sliding back as the wind is pushing on you.
Yes! 20.
You manage to just, you tumble backward a little bit, you grab a couple of feathers and get yourself just on the side underneath where the wing meets the part of the upper torso, where the wind resistance is the least amount, and you manage to hold on. So you're now clutching the back of this giant bird.
Okay.
That's your turn.
You gotta be
real level.
What the shit?
See her a little bit below there.
The way you kick so much ass like nobody else.
Scanlan.
The way you do animal things gets me overwhelmed. You don't know. You don't know you're powerful. That's what makes you powerful.
Due to the wind, you don't hear the last line. It's too loud around it. But however, you do take a D10 inspiration dice.
What a heroic move!
Which, for the record, this currently right now looks like you see the cow clutched below, and currently there is a cow holding on to this.
Yeah, it lasts 8 hours.
You see a teeny tiny cow.
You're on it.
Don't worry about me.
Really?
No, I'm fine. You never need to worry about me. Haven't you guys learned that by now? No. I'm fine.
Out of thematic reasons, I also turn him into a cow.
That's amazing!
Rolled one.
I'm a cow on a cow with a cow!
Like a cow! This
giant flying bird.
Oh my god.
It just begins to plummet at an extremely. Alright, so. You guys are now both plummeting. And falling at a really, really rapid speed.
I go eagle cows. Form.
You go eagle form? Zoom. You're fine. Another two rounds before you impact with something very painful.
But he's like as heavy as a dust mote, so he just kind of goes like this all the way down, right?
He's a calf.
That's how it works.
I will become a pterodactyl.
So you're casting
polymorph on myself?
Come on, Scanlan!
That's a natural 20. Oh! Oh, snap! Nope, not concentration. It just lasts for 8 hours.
They're all still flying cows.
We're still flying cows.
They're all still just a squadron of flying illusory cows.
Yeah.
But you guys are both now transformed into an eagle and a pterodactyl.
But we still
look like cows.
Yeah.
And we shan't bother you or your people any further.
I bow deeply, and when I do, it goes. Ding, ding, ding.
For a moment, you think you hear a slight, uncontrollable chuckle from the gnome.
Tomorrow is Sam Riegel's birthday.
Oh my gosh.
Nipples! Is it really?
And I have a birthday present for him tonight.
What?
Something that I commissioned the lovely Kit Bus to make for you.
What? It's Vaxmas?
It's Vaxmas.
I'm not looking.
I made this just for you, and by made this.
Oh wow, that's really nice! I thought it was gonna be vulgar. Me and two ladies, what could be better, right?
Yeah.
I guess three.
Three ladies.
Yeah. Wait, can I make a request that the rest of us do the sounds of the ricocheting bullets in case he misses?
Certainly. Okay.
That's a misfire.
So the pepper box, you go to the shoot, and there you go. The actual barrel gets clogged and there's a burst of flame. It rattled the flame.
Okay, that's all I want.
Okay.
Don't have to do it every time. Wait, Trinket missed?
To
missed
grapple the impeder.
Doesn't matter. Did you miss? Anyway. Okay. I missed it.
Second shot.
I'll move towards him.
All right.
And then, then I see a crazy thing in front of me.
Yep. Yes, you do.
Shit. So I probably take a couple steps back.
Okay.
Nope. And then I'll just inspire Percy.
Alrighty.
All the single Percys! All the single Percys! All the single Percys! Put your guns up!
I'm tossing it into my room. Okay. I'm using an action surge. Actually, can I even do that? Yes, I'm going to use my action surge, and I'm going to
gently fall asleep under Percy's workbench.
I really wouldn't do that.
Where I've been hiding this whole time.
Okay, make a stealth check.
You're not going to sleep down there.
Natural 20.
You go about your work as is necessary.
I'm fixing my gun.
Okay.
The
materials that yes. It requires you to do so are expensive. You actually have to pay the cost of the gun and go ahead and make another check.
What the fuck is that sound?
Percy was trying to sleep.
Go for it.
What's your goal? You can recommend a song.
My
what would you like?
Here comes the sun.
I've got plus.
Lack of experience.
Here comes the sun. It's all right. Chainmail chokers.
Chainmail dickies.
And a small one of a dick.
All righty.
A little tiny one.
She awkwardly
four links
has
connected together.
Judge and turns that request down.
Oh. I will put it where I put all gentle things.
Oh dear.
Ew.
That yep. I trust.
Pants
I trust that more.
Pants
fine.
That bad boy.
Good.
Ooh. You do not make the wisest decisions.
Was once holy.
Oh yes. I drink my shit scrying potion, shit in a jar, and leave it in the kitchen.
Okay.
Don't touch it. Have we given them a raise?
I just gave him two to fucking
him.
Double
the rest
guard
of
on
the rest of
double
the people.
Double the guard on him.
And yeah.
Just five of them make 100 a month. I give 100. Five of them make 100 a month. Two of them make 50 a month.
I give another 200 to him and tell him to pass it out to the rest of the guard.
I go invisible and see if I can hear their conversation. 20.
Oh shit.
Okay. You were keeping relatively low and able to overhear their conversation. Okay.
You know, you're a very brilliant person, but
thank you.
I can't help but feel like I'm being watched right now, but that's never mind. Just forget I said anything.
Yep.
Throw it away. I do regret what happened. And I know he was a bad man, but I hope to never lose my temper like that again.
I don't really feel like we're being watched. Do you feel that?
Ever since.
She's like, I don't know.
Be Grog, Vex, and Trinket.
I approve of that.
Just your first level.
Oh. Well, Trinket's
no, 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 no.
Not worth to say.
I'll give him a shut up, Scanlan.
Wake him up.
I instantly felt guilty, dick.
You guilted him up to another level.
Yeah, you did. Okay. So I
would have done a cantrip,
dick.
All right, that's pretty good.
That's not bad.
That's an 8 and a.
Do I have to heal Trinket anymore?
No, he's okay.
Okay, then I will. I don't hurt things very well.
You
do what,
you're do
gonna
what
do.
You do.
I hurt feelings.
Okay.
You do you, Scanlan.
Okay. I'll do some Bigby's hand, some Bigby's hand. I summon Bigby's hand. Bigby's hand. I do one of these, the Sugar Ray Leonard. I do this, and then I throw that hand forward, and I'll just punch him in the face.
Go for it. I like that.
Okay, so the clenched fish.
Correct.
Clenched fish.
Clenched fish attack.
Clenched is the one you're talking about. Yes. On fire.
Oh no!
13.
As the fist swings out, it whoosh, ducks out of the way. Its serpentine body ducking as the fist just arcs off into the middle of the air.
Good try, Scanlan.
Oh boy.
Good.
He's Grog. He's big. He's strong like wood. He's better than bad, he's good.
Very Everyone wants a grog. That's your turn, because it'll take you the rest
just
of the turn.
Just say your soul is forfeit, just for coolness.
This normally doesn't happen to me. I don't quite know what.
I still have my Bigby's hand up, so I kind of do one of these where I say, oh, wise guy, see? Oh! And I just poke him in the eyes.
All right. 19 points of force damage as you jam both of its fingers into the sides of its head. Both of its eyes recoil on it.
I hide behind Trinket.
All right.
Percy next?
Percy's next.
Okay, I will inspire Percy.
Thank you.
I'll just start like doing this move.
And I
put some Scanlan on you.
Ah.
When you need a hand. And I get closer.
Oh, God.
Scale it up.
The downgrade? The
yes.
The,
a ramp.
Ramp.
A slope.
Thank you.
A ramp.
Yeah. A ramp that disappears below into the lower floor.
A sigil.
I'm gonna go into that.
Careful. Careful. No, don't roll! We turn on him.
I'm still like down there investigating.
Mm-hmm.
And I pull a David Caruso and I say, it looks like these giants had big trouble.
Oh, you hear in the distance an echoing sound go, yeah!
You can ride me into town.
Oh, hello, lady.
Every time, Scanlan, every time.
Yeah, no, that just got weird.
Can you turn yourself into like...
Oh yeah, I guess I could fly.
You want to go invisible and then jump on my back and I can eagle up?
Whatever you're into, baby.
Let's do
I've
it.
Become awesome.
Ridiculous! Ridiculous!
Now you cannot see Keyleth. You're just grasping onto something you can't see, and you just look like you're gliding through the air.
Can I do one of these?
Yeah, you grab on very tightly, not without choking. It's the eagle does not have human physiology. You get a two fists full of feathers. All right.
Thunder.
Oh, feathers.
Thunder.
What's that from?
I don't know. We're gonna be insurgents?
Shh! Let him finish the plan.
What? I kind of love this.
Okay. It'll scar anything. Oh. It just creates very, very high heat.
Like a mark.
Like a brand.
Like a mark. Like a mark. Like our mark.
Like a mark.
Like our mark.
Not our mark.
The resistance.
The resistance.
I need a beret.
Concentrating on Pike, about 2 minutes of hard concentration. There's no connection.
They wiped my poo away.
You gather, due to the relatively fresh and unstable nature of this potion you had concocted, you can only have one source connection up at a time. So when you left it in your keep, it seems that the one you had at the Temple of Saren Rae was alleviated of its magical presence. So what was once a magical scry poo is literally just scan-scat.
Which some could argue is magical in its own right.
Does it change color when it loses its power?
You don't know.
Damn it! I want to know!
Only one way to find out.
God damn it.
Ask Pike when you see her again.
We can actually, your poo power may come in very handy.
Could we throw in a Scanlan grenade and be able to see through it?
Sure.
Pull the pin.
Yes. Remember
this
that.
Is what,
that's
this
awesome.
Is what happens. This is what happens.
You could fly overhead with Keyleth.
Yes.
Drop it like a ball!
And then we'd have eyes in there.
So, everyone, we have our Sam arrived and...
Samurai.
We have our Sam arrived.
That's new.
Lauren Travis in transit. They'll be here as soon as they... Well played.
Percival, do you want to come upstairs to the window?
I'm coming.
And, you're coming too? All right.
Yeah, of course.
Let's go. You're my son. Let's go.
And one child-looking...
peasant.
Popper of a boy wandering through the city alone towards the graveyard. Gives you a curious look as if he hasn't seen you before, but doesn't seem to.
Good day, sir.
Okay. And just keeps rolling along, the wheels kind of squeaking as he pushes up the road.
I wish I had a yo-yo.
How about a wheel and stick?
Oh, the wheel and stick would be good.
It's really the classic. This is my neighborhood. I feel comfortable.
All right, Papa, let's go.
Did you have a short sword? I remember you having a short.
Everything I have is short.
Actually, I
can
have...
just go in there and open it from the inside. Open it from the inside. Open it from the inside.
With a burst of kind of dark purplish energy, Scanlan steps through the door, leaving no mark or trace behind. On the other side, you hear this muffled You appear now in the central worship hall of the Zenith Temple.
Scanlan, open the door.
All right, how big is this thing that's keeping the door shut?
It's about 8 feet wide. It's wood. It's porous.
And how high off the ground? Could I touch it?
You can touch it. It gets to about your head a little higher.
All right, I'm going to try to lift it off.
Go ahead and make a strength check. Athletics. Make this athletics.
Athletics. This is 12.
Oh, you know, it's not that.
From this position, it's not even budging.
Oh, no.
Right, Scanlan.
Yo, oi!
Step back from the door a couple of paces. I'm going to stick a blade through the door.
It's not
going to
do much. There's a big, heavy, heavy thing.
I'm going to hold on one side, you're going to hold on the other, and we'll do it together. All right, Scanlan, grab some rags or something, wrap it around the blade. You're going to lift on your side, we're going to lift on this side.
I get the sharp side?
I can't get the handle through the crack in the door.
All right. I feel like there's some sort of spell I could use. All right, let's just do it your way.
Got that baby's hand? Is that in
yeah, theater? I've got like a million things I could do, but let's do it this way. No. I want to follow this through. Let's keep going.
All right, can we lift it together?
We can try.
Right. Okay.
This is going to be the three of you as a skill challenge. I want all three of you to roll... not athletics, just a straight strength roll.
Wait, did you get a four? Four! We're the worst! This is the weakest Oh, I cut my hand!
Which is exactly what happens, actually.
Big hand.
I'm gonna take damage.
First and foremost, you take 4 points of slashing damage.
Of course.
To your hand. You pull back, and there's a line of blood now. We're gonna drip off your hand.
I can't say goddammit in here. I'm in Pelor's. Sorry. Man. All right. Well, geez, Louise.
What about the purple hand, man?
Seems like overkill. What about just a thunder wave? Can I do that?
Certainly.
All right.
Wait. Scanlan, are there any windows in there?
They said the window was broken.
Oh, there are windows. Good call.
It's a blast of thunderous energy in an area. It would affect living and non-living matter.
Yes. Hold on, this is stupid.
Are you sure?
We're going to the window. We're going to the window.
No. Let's carry this out.
No, we're going to the window. Please do not destroy the temple.
3 hours later, we're still trying to open the door.
It's not even locked. It's just heavy-ish.
I could probably lift that door, the door bar from inside.
Yeah, lift
that. Oh, yeah, you could probably.
With your help, son.
Yeah, but I could blast it. It'd be very dramatic.
Let's save that for
later.
Important stuff. All right, so where's the window?
The saga of the door.
It's just a door, you guys.
Hey, oi! Your stupid idea cut my hand. Builds character.
You want to help me lift this thing?
With my good hand.
Come on, Shorty.
All right. Have both you guys make strength checks.
All right.
You know what? I'm gonna get some assistance. I call my unseen servant to assist.
Okay.
He's gonna lift with us.
Somewhat humanoid in shape, but still amorphous, appears.
Hi, Daryl.
And begins to shove itself up against the bottom of the wooden bar. So make a check as well.
Well, that was a six. Right? No?
Roll again and add five.
Oh, I see.
You got a six.
Four. So that's nine.
The three of you, one mystically summoned from a plane beyond your own, cannot seem to budge this single wooden door. You've defeated beholders. You've slaughtered Ithilien underneath. In the Underdark, deep in the belly of the planet. But this door bests you.
Man, Lauren and Travis ain't missing shit.
All right, I'm doing it. Step back.
Whip out the hand.
All right, I summon Bigby's hand, the mightiest hand that will ever unlock a door, ever. Bigby's hand! Plus 8, 20.
How you want to do this?
One of his fingers just goes, and it...
With one finger?
The door
overkill.
Opens up and Percy stands there looking not
Was
very
it
happy.
Overkill? Because really it took that.
It took three spells
it's
to
exactly
open this door!
It took.
Three
it's
spells!
Not, it's not overkill if you use what it took.
Three spells and I injured myself.
We took damage from an inanimate object. Oh, God.
It freaks you out, but then you remember the knowledge your friends are here, and you have a sort of purpose, and you shake off any sort of...
Not only do I shake it off...
You had a breakfast.
I gird my loins.
You had your weenies.
Pull them up and get ready.
We've been listening in the car.
It's cool.
Okay, so you know.
Yeah. So, Scalen, you move back.
Okay, and then I can, as a bonus action, I still get a bonus, I will heal him, this doofus here.
Okay.
I didn't do anything.
Healing word.
Okay, yeah.
So go ahead.
I'm bringing health points back. Yeah. No motherfuckers don't know how to act. Yeah. Oh, that's all I got. Take it to the root. fuck. I'll cast Bigby's hand at 6th level then.
Okay. Okay.
Has that ever been done?
I don't have any more 5th level slots, so I'm just gonna make it even bigger.
Alrighty.
I don't even know what it does.
Fingers going out the windows of the church like Alice in Wonderland.
So many fingers. All the fingers. As you hear it scream out in pain, as its spectral form is scattered across the air and dissipates.
Oh!
The whale
you killed it!
What?
Oh, thank God.
What? I think you smashed
you
it.
Did it.
Killed it.
Crushed it.
But I'm so little and wee.
Lift yourself up for a victory lap.
Yes, I lift myself up with Big Baby's hand. That's a great idea.
You toss yourself a couple times. Or deception check, if you prefer.
Deception, please.
All right.
Do-do-do-do-do, I'm just a peasant boy. Can I go talk to them?
You can indeed.
Okay.
I'm gonna come with you.
Okay.
All right, as they're both kind of walking by, kind of keeping the hush, they see you guys kind of sit in the same alley. They stop for a second, kind of looking you over, and give a nod.
Oh, excuse me.
Those crazy eyes.
My papa sent me to send a present, a gift of sorts, to a Sir Kirin. We're just looking to see where we can deliver the gift.
Make a deception check.
Scanlon's forte, come on.
29.
Blink, blink.
They both kind of stop and...
You give good urchin.
The man kind of gives her a look like, he's trying to usher her along, kind of pulling her arm, and she goes, no, no, honey, it's just a child. Walks up and kind of leans forward and says, if you're looking for Sir Carrion, you'll find him in the extravagant abode to the southeast of the city.
The one right over there.
No. You don't want to go find the Countess there. You're not from here, are you?
No.
We're new to town.
She's blind.
Well, just do what he says. Don't question. All right?
Okay. I just need to bring him this sack of presents because my papa will whip me pretty bad.
TMI.
Then perhaps you could do that quickly.
Oh, you're so pretty and clean.
She kind of gives blushes for a second. It's like, oh. you stay safe, and kind of like brushes the hair out of your eyes for a second and kind of pinches your cheek a little
bit.
And you know, there's a look of sadness in her eyes, almost like, what horrible fate befalls this child? She's not
I
careful.
Smack him on the back of the head.
Grandmama,
and
I'm
say,
sorry.
Let's go,
I'm sorry.
Boy. Keep up.
She recoils.
I'm her seeing eye boy.
She rushes back to the side of the man with her. And, see, it's fine. Good luck. And they both kind of dart off down the alley again.
Sam Riegel, ladies and gentlemen, played Gavroche in Les Mis.
Gavroche,
right here. Gavroche.
Sam Riegel. Sam Riegel, everybody.
On Broadway.
Consider yourself.
See if we can draw him out of his house.
Ooh, that's a
I
cool
will say,
plan. I like that plan.
It is raining.
Oh wait, but I would be bait.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. We'll see. As they go, I just quickly like I lock eyes with Grog, and I just give him a quick little inspiration. Blood, glorious blood. Grog's about to take some dead dudettes and. Dudes. Grog's about to make some.
Trinket is unable to
I know,
climb.
It's a ladder.
Oh, can I? Trinket, stay.
I smack the back of your head again. And it's hard because I'm angry right now.
You're as cold as ice! Willing to sacrifice your boss! And so I tell him to kill his boss.
Oh, that's what's
itself and exploding with a burst of electricity, a third one strikes him in the chest.
After she does that, I say, that was my grandma!
That's right, boy!
little boy.
Adding to the confusion.
Yeah.
And I will inspire her as well.
Okay.
Yay.
Do you want a detail? Okay.
I do.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
Every time, man.
You have to. Vex be nimble, Vex be quick. Vex jump on the limbo stick. Now you don't know how you're gonna react because Vex has an attack. Oi!
I don't get it.
You take your D10 inspiration. Yay. Confused, but accept the inspiration.
Take 5 minutes of that.
A chuckle in the middle of a hearty battle is always worth a little inspiration.
You charmed.
That's not my guy. That's not my guy, man.
There,
oh, that guy is. Yeah. Oh wait, he's attacking my guy?
No, he's attacking.
Oh, that's great.
The guy's invisible. Yeah.
I walk next to him and sort of distract him with a little soft shoot.
Tell him, right. Thank you. That's what I needed.
I'm Helga, the angry tavern wench, and I only love one man. Scanlan.
Oh. That's fantastic. Yep. Other side of the table. Let's see.
Oh, look who just showed up.
Who are you dressed as, Sam?
I'm either a porn actor or Burt Reynolds. I can't smile. It's Smokey and the Bandit. I can't get him to stay.
That's okay. We'll find some duct tape for you.
My costume is awesome.
Bert, your mustache is falling off.
That's
it is?
Not me.
You know, the situation is very dire. I don't know why I'm laughing. It's kind of a nervous habit. I'm sorry.
Speaking of nervous habits,
one of us has a nervous habit of ejecting smoke from his rib cage. What are you talking about? We all knew what we were doing when we... Pay attention to me. I'm trying to be serious here. Don't you turn your eyes away from me. Look at me when I'm talking to you.
I'm very upset.
We all
right
knew
now.
What we were doing when we went into the house.
I don't believe you're really sick, darling.
Vex, I've heard a cough like that, and it's probably syphilis.
Lovely. Thank you, Scanlan.
It's personal experience. One that's time. All I'm saying. Yep. Hey, Hepcat. Yes. I'm wanting to get a beat on the vibe.
Does manage to catch its fangs and deflect the attack initially.
Hey!
A piece of metal thing? Yeah. Hey, I made that! I call it a Scanlan. I call everything a Scanlan. I'll use my movement because I just woke up to pee. Because I just woke up, I gotta pee.
Do you have morning?
It's midnight wood.
Okay.
Midnight wood.
Scanlan,
so it's probably gonna go everywhere.
You're nice, acting like you're Botox.
I know.
I can't move my lips.
So, Scanlan, you use your movement to pee. All right, so your face.
While I'm peeing.
Yeah.
I whip out.
Oh no.
My wand of magic missiles.
Jesus.
And I point it, and I use it. I use 4 of the slots.
Burt Reynolds should play with us more often.
You've got the best old man laugh ever.
This guy's the brains of the operation.
You get up. Spraying an arc.
By the way, I'm holding my dick with one hand and the wand with the other.
So you're dual wielding. Okay.
I'm dual wielding.
Are you proficient in this?
I think Scanlan's pretty proficient in this, I'm just saying. Alright, so.
And they're both spraying everywhere.
Oh, God.
Happy Halloween. As you sign your signature on the ground, you also burst forth with a series of arcane bolts that streak across the room, slamming into the sides of each of these vampires, and their heads all turn curiously as to what they see. Not what they were expecting.
Don't worry, I won't wash my hands. I need Grog to rage and get us through this semi-fucked kind of fight. Baby, baby.
Okay. You're going to
wow!
Kill, kill, kill.
It's true.
I would smile right now if I could.
Just want to tickle you.
You're so attractive tonight for some reason. Have we been together?
What?
Are you using a new conditioner?
Oh, you and I have been together.
Those little ponytails out.
Did you see?
Ooh, look at that.
I carved that in with a pen myself. After our night together. Oh. Where have you been my whole life? Sorry.
It's canon.
Reach around, Scanlan. I'm doing another.
You're reaching around. You're doing a reach around, okay?
My
dick is out.
I kind of see as I reach around, and I'm like, oh, really? And I'm blasting.
A little privacy, please.
Shield your eyes.
All right. So.
Instinctively cover my penis.
Oh my goodness.
It's more important than my eyes. That steak was well done.
Yeah! That was so CSI Miami.
Your mustache is almost down to your chin for a goatee.
And I'll just say,
bringing out the big guns.
What's up? What's up, Toothy? Hey, bite me. That's it. That's all I do. It's 3d4.
That it is. That was about 3d4 worth.
Okay. That's all I got. Wasn't ready.
What's up, Toothy? Bite me.
8 points. How do you want to do this?
Yes. I mean, that's how I want to do it. I want to do some pelvic thrusting while I'm sitting. Bite me! Bite me hard! Bite me, motherfucker! Bite me!
Urine flying everywhere.
Oh, shit.
Bounces up and down.
Oh, there's urine everywhere. My mustache is falling off. It's terrible.
So, as it's trying to take its chances, it turns to go and flee, sees Grog, looks over, and hears you going, hey! Hey, Toothy, looks over back at you. One of the weaknesses of a vampire is running water. The bit of your
constellation urine.
Yes. Streaks across the front of the vampire as it turns around, and Grog just instinctually slams it with a hammer and smashes it into the ground. It's hard to say which killed it. You're pretty sure it was you.
Good job, Scanlan.
High five.
Not until you wash.
Stress ball.
Yes. Which, for the record, as you high five him, there was a bit of spatter across your hand.
Oh, there's no gnome like our gnome. Oh my god.
So I'm Tasimas?
Yes.
As peasants again?
Yes.
Same peasants, yes.
Different looking peasants.
Seeming. Feel me. Touch me. Heal me.
Sorry, folks.
I'm a cute little boy with a lazy eye. To match my grandma.
So there you go.
I didn't want to disturb your announcement.
Sit down, you dickless wonder.
Oh, it's just a sleeping monkey.
Okay.
My God.
Easy, Helga. Oh. It was. You meant nothing to me.
Still so little expression on that face, dude.
I don't know what you're saying. I can perform perfectly.
I've moved on from Scanlan, and I have cut my hair as a sign of change.
And spit as I talk and say, I need a hard drink. I pull Scanlan by the ear. Come on, you shit!
Call Child Protective Service.
All right, I pull Jimmy John after me and sit down next to one of them.
My name is Tad.
Shut up.
Tad.
Two here, and one of him.
What? Okay, I'll be right back. And he walks off, looking a little confused.
I'll have one of what he's having as well.
That's cute. Water it is. He's just walking off.
Been trying to grow fucking carrots for these fucking people. Can't earn a living!
Totally. Ain't no living to be had in Whitestone these days.
I can't feed him.
It's
what are we fucking supposed to do here?
I haven't eaten in 3 days.
Someone should run these fuckers out of town.
That ain't gonna happen, mate. Sorry.
I have a friend named Kevin. He says there is someone trying to do something about it. He says that that's what caused that fire yesterday over at that big fancy house.
He says there's
rebels afoot.
I take the mug that I have and I pour the rest of it out on this little one's head.
You say you speak when you're spoken to.
No, 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 it's okay. Let the boys speak.
They're talking.
I'm sorry,
Let
Papa,
your boys
don't hit me.
Speak. What were you saying?
Oh, I'm just saying what I overheard. My friend Kevin, he's truthful. When he lies, his papa beats him, so I believe him. He said that someone really strong took out someone who was at that big fancy house that was all aflame the other day. He said that there's lots of them, and that they're going to free us all from this hell we live in.
Meg. Oh man, that's a layered check. A persuasion and a deception roll back to back.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, persuasion, 39.
What?
How? Is that possible?
Deception, 15.
Wait, or 29. It's a lot.
It's probably 29.
What's your 16? Bonus to persuasion?
No, it's 16 plus 13.
Okay, so 29.
That's 29. Sorry. Okay, sorry, I was like, sorry. It's a lot.
39.
Well, the uprising 3 years ago. Are you new to this fucking town?
3 years ago, Papa wouldn't let me out of the closet, so I didn't hear much of what was going on.
Okay, first and foremost, you gotta treat your boy better.
I'm sorry about my papa. He's had such a hard time these last few years. Our crops are not performing well, and he's under a lot of pressure, and, well, I think Mama doesn't love him anymore. I'm sorry. We can go.
One thing, if he ever does anything else to hurt you again, you can tell someone. Two, if you hear anything else about this savior coming into town, go ahead and talk to Trevor over there at the edge of the bar, because the rest of us would like to go out in a blaze of glory than live in this bullshit.
What was your name, sir?
Not important to much, but you can call me Patrick.
Thank you, Patrick. Come on, Papa, let's go. I turn around and I just take the rest of his drink.
You, Scanlan, skipping along, the boy that you are, with your one weird wandering eye. You turn into a fly and make your way through the bars and begin over the yard with your 1/20th of a hit point in fly form.
I'll just perch on like the handrail or door frame or something just above him and just kind of wait.
Okay. He takes notice of your buzzing as you go by and just kind of...
How about you wait 30 seconds and go?
Got it.
All right. I turn into a Triceratops.
What? I'm going to say, roll an intelligence check.
19.
Okay. You have heard of some of these, one of which is the mighty and frightening Triceratops. You hear it's just a fable, but it's kind of fun to pretend to be one, sure.
Three horns and big.
Yep, and out of nowhere, this tiny fly swoosh into a Triceratops. Boom! Lands and... crushing the man beneath you, it's prone beneath you right now.
And for my move, I bash down the door.
The loud cracking sound, the doorway and most of that side of the room is just thrashed and destroyed. Wood chunks go flying everywhere with a loud roar. You see the part of the inside of the foyer collapses. You hear voices begin yelling out from in the household, and immediately five guards start rushing in from different rooms towards you. I understand. And we will pick up at this moment next week.
Oh, whoa! Damn it! No!
But I'm a dinosaur!
I know. So.
Let's do this!
Oh, God.
Without further ado, Sam.
Oh! But I was just handed this.
I know, take a look. Take your time.
Sucks to be first.
He's got the maps out already.
Oh god.
Get your shit together, man. I've never been a Triceratops before. All right, yes, you're right. Think like a Triceratops.
So they didn't fix the air, right? They didn't fix the air.
I need shelter. No, I don't know how do Triceratopses think.
You are. I did not have a Triceratops, but I did have a Stegosaurus. As you slam your way into the front of Duke Vedmeyer's estate, pieces of wood blasting outward, scattering amongst the center of the foyer. You see before you a rising staircase that divides into two separate staircases that curl around to the second level.
Lovely decor.
You also notice.
Oh shit!
At first notice that the entire interior is currently filled with guards. In case you
I think
see,
I can take them, guys. I think I can take them.
You also see at the top Duke Vedmire himself, large, hairless, gray-skinned Goliath wielding a giant two-handed sword.
Okay, Vedmire. Is it Goliath?
It's Goliath, yeah.
Vedmire's Goliath.
Wow, that's gonna be fun later, but not right
Downtown.
Now. Damn it!
You made a very loud noise when you turned into a Triceratops and then tore through the front of the household. All right, so Scanlan is up first.
You're still
I'm
first.
So yeah. So you're here's the thing. Here's the thing. I should probably leave.
Yeah, come on.
Yes. But come on, I'm a Triceratops. I gotta have some fun first, right?
You can take a couple hit points, right?
Right?
Yeah. Yeah,
Scanlan, what are you doing? You have initiative. What are you doing?
I'm gonna turn right and blast through that door.
Okay.
Yeah, all right.
I'm gonna get shot, so I'm just going through the door. Oh shit, it could be trapped. Oh, well, we'll find out.
We'll find out.
That's only a 17.
17?
Just for a door.
That's gonna do.
That's
me and doors don't get along too well. Well, shit. Then I gotta get some retribution.
Totally. Turn around and give it to him.
Am I considered flanked?
You are not.
Damn it! I don't know how to hit things. I've never hit things before.
As you blast through, it's a dining room with a central dining room table.
I should get out of there. But it's so fun.
What do you want to do, Scanlan?
So I'm in the room. No one's in there with me.
Correct.
I will hold my attack till anyone runs through the door. They get an insta-gore.
Okay. Good to know. Kind of hear you right around the corner. These guys are gonna dash in.
Oh god.
There.
I think I can take them, guys.
There.
Okay, tell me this. Did I hear a bunch of footsteps? Can
you
I
heard
hear?
Heard a bunch of footsteps.
I'm not good at fighting. I will.
Can you set a blaze?
I will drop. I don't have any fire. I don't know why I was sent into this mission. I don't do fire things.
Don't you have a torch? Or a lantern?
Triceratops. Shrinks down to gnomish form now in this partially destroyed dining room area.
How did this plan happen then?
It's a great
We're a bunch of
slapdicks. Why did you say I don't have fire?
I mean, I guess I could have.
I said, hey, Scanlan, I should come with you, and you said, I could take care of myself. How many times do I have to tell you guys I don't need your help?
The echoing voice you hear in the back of your mind as you imagine this is what Keyleth would be saying right now.
I just kind of peek around the corner. A little bit, just okay. Make sure they're all there.
Yeah.
And I will stinking cloud all of them.
Okay. All right.
Why are you not mentioning Dorian there? I gotta have some fun first. Yeah. How often am I gonna take on a whole house by myself?
I'm so in love with you right now.
I approve of this plan.
The foyer just fills up with this greenish, noxious cloud of poisonous gas. Double nope because he's on the ground. Fuck that guy. Vedmire rolls a one. One of them starts just vomiting all over the ground. He has a helmet on, so it's kind of like strained through its
muscles. Yes!
Oh!
Yeah.
Okay, I'll do like a Dukes of Hazzard over the table.
Alright.
Unnecessarily.
Do I have to make an athletics check or anything for that?
I'll make him do an acrobatics to see how cool it was.
11.
You. You slide only because you partially destroyed it as a Triceratops and to the other side, but in your head it looked pretty cool. Thank God none of your allies were around to actually witness it, but you heard the theme music.
Okay, yeah. God, I so want to get some payback, but I shouldn't, right?
GTFO.
I think I can take these guys.
God, you were really like the drunk guy.
One more round. What do you say, guys?
We're not here.
Yeah, okay.
You're talking
one
to yourself
more round.
Right now.
Okay, I will duck under the table,
okay.
So they think that's where I went.
Okay.
And then dimension door to the roof.
Okay. Okay, so you duck under the table. I'm gonna say make a deception roll to try and successfully feint them.
31.
So you
we think
grab
you
your head. Down. Oh no! Do like a very elaborate dive under the table.
Do I go under the table? Poof.
A little strange, dull thud of arcane energy as you bamf up to the ceiling.
Oh wait, I do have something.
Yeah, you do?
We do.
Yeah, I have a potion of fire breath.
You do.
Okay.
Yep. I don't know how it works.
You're checking your pockets, you find the potion, you look down, you notice, even through the storm...
You know what, I'll just try it. I will fire breath potion myself.
Okay, you pull up, pull the cork off.
I don't know what this thing does, I just got this.
As you feel the fluid find its way down your esophagus, it warms it like a fine whiskey would, but the warmth just grows and grows. This need to belch is burbling within your stomach, and at any given point in time, you could let that belch fly forward.
Okay, so I'm just gonna kinda lean over the side and just scorch the whole front entrance as much as I can.
Okay. As you let the belch out, it comes out in a large spray of orange, yellow, and red flames that immediately burst beneath the overhang. So this gnome appears, soaking wet, over the edge of the roof and then just releases this gout of fire that blankets the front of the building. Grab their crossbows and aim them up towards you.
It's just your hands and head are sticking.
That's a 17.
That hits.
And a 13.
Doesn't he have at least half cover from the roof?
He does. It would hit, except for, that's a good point. You would have half cover from looking over the rooftop. You only have a little bit of your hands and your face showing.
What we're here for.
So both go firing off into the rainstorm.
Because I'm a gnome, do I always have half cover?
No, but it's easier for you to find it. They angrily reach down and duck back inside the building with the rest of their movement to get out of the range of now what appears to be a flame-throwing gnome.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
It's amazing.
You're doing so well.
Not that we ever do.
Yeah.
I don't know if that house is cooked enough, man.
I know, maybe you should just keep burning it.
Yeah, so I'll run over to the back side of the house and do the same thing.
Okay. Just unleash on the opposite side. Both sides of the house now appear to be on fire. Looking over your shoulder, you can see now there's a pillar of black smoke rising up from the front of the building. You also do see on the opposite side a hatch slam open, and you see a giant, meaty Goliath hand.
Oh no! Shit! Oh!
How close is his hatch to the edge?
It's about 25 feet from either the front or the back side. It's like right in the center of the house, or close to it. Okay. What you got, Scanlan? What you got?
I'm trying. Just seeing range here. My spellcasting ability modifier is what?
It's charisma.
It's charisma. It's 5 times 5. 25. That's 25 feet. Okay.
Yeah.
Big B's hand! So I call forth Big B's hand and I
call forth.
I will force him off the roof.
Yeah!
Yes!
Okay. Oh, this will be interesting.
I want to fly away. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Go ahead and make a strength check with the hand.
Shit, he's strong.
The strength is +8 with, so add 8 to this roll.
17 plus 8.
Oh! Natural 1. Of course!
You've been eating it today! Oh my god!
Of course.
I'm gonna kill everyone in this motherfucking house!
He seems holding against it, but the hand eventually scoops him up and actually gets him off of his feet and like shock puts him off the roof. He plummets backward, off the side of the roof, and you wait a second to hear a poof.
I'll hoof it over there, and okay, then
over to the hatch, just, which is right up there.
I'll look around and kind of punch myself in the gut.
Okay, there are two guards that are currently making their way up to the roof. They look up and see you. Their eyes go wide within their helmets, and as you release the flames, all you see is their faces go engulfing the entire tunnel.
What do you mean? You used all your spell slots?
Okay, so I'm just gonna. I'm jumping in the rain. So I'm gonna jump off the. Can I go away from the Goliath? Okay, I look back at them and I do that thing where you just kind of do this. I trust fall off the back of it. But I'm going to simultaneously make Bigby's hand try to catch me.
You trust fall off?
Oh.
your eyes kind of somewhat closed and letting it happen.
Come on, big me, catch me.
And in the moment that you expect ground to meet you with a heavy, hard smack of reality, a soft cushion of arcane energy catches you as these kind of spiritual, you know, purplish fingers curl around and gently bring you to the ground.
Like Baymax.
Don't get handsy, big me.
Austin Powers.
So I'll just start running.
Okay. So you start running
my little
this way.
Tiny nubby, my tiny little nubby legs.
Okay.
They're attacking the zombie giant. That's good.
You have inspired people.
It's
GTFO,
working.
Man.
It's working.
Oh no.
I lived.
I like that Scanlan took out an entire house,
dude,
and we're all probably gonna die.
You were fucking Rambo just then. Yeah. You were Scanlan Rambo.
You're a legend.
You are.
You're officially a legend.
Do you have any red cloth you can tear off and tie around your forehead?
Because you're.
Do
yeah.
this. Is your beret yeah. still on?
Yes.
I never got a beret. Did I get a beret?
You did get a beret. I thought you got a beret.
I wanted
that
a beret.
That's outstanding.
All
yes.
right. I approve of this greatly.
A natural 20! Woo!
You got a natural
20.
For the bear? Woo!
On the crit. All right.
That was a critical roar. No.
11 for the first. And then...
So sour. It was sweet.
I go upstairs and I... get Percy up against a wall. I turn around and slam against a wall.
Okay.
This is sexy.
27. And I look him straight in the eye.
And kiss him.
And I say...
Stop encouraging.
Oh, something's happening! Something's happening in the sky!
That's me.
I think it's a magic wielder of some sort. Something... I must flee.
All right.
Hi. How'd it go?
Good work, by the way. That was awesome. I mean, I could just—I saw the fire.
So
I don't know
yeah.
what you did, but
well,
I set fire to the place. Some shit went down. Dinosaurs were harmed.
Oh.
But I know that you got the smoke signal and used that to attack.
The Dorolos have dinosaurs.
No, no, it was me. Okay. Health. We need some now. Health. Not just anybody. Health. You know, you need someone. Help! What's his name again? Tyleri?
Tyleri.
Mm-hmm. He was a vampire.
Yes.
Because Silas killed him.
Yes.
Didn't he hang him on the sun tree?
No.
What? No.
What?
No.
What are you talking about?
What?
I don't know. Didn't that guy that we meet...
You do recall, actually, when you were interrogating the driver of the Briarwoods, where Briarwood took Desmond, and to try and show extension of faith, revealed to Desmond Tyleri hanging from the sun tree.
Wow.
That was true.
Wow.
And then he became a vampire.
Aren't you excited?
I'm ready to
Are
announce
you excited?
It.
You're so ready.
What is
it's
it?
Crazy.
Okay, so Critical Role is finally getting a weekly comic strip.
Is that true?
Yes.
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 I'm famous.
Yes.
You've made it.
I did it. I want to go up there. Pike's up there.
I look at Scanlan and I say, go get it. And I grab Scanlan by the back and I throw him up onto the wall.
Scanlan leaps up and you land next to Pike.
Hi, baby. It's been so long. Man, you look good. Oh, man. I'm so distracted by your beauty. Hey, let's kick some ass together, shall we?
Come on, let's go.
By the way, can I just say, that's my girlfriend who just did that. She jumped 35 feet out there?
She did, yes.
Can I do that?
If you want to try.
Try.
She rolled a natural 20.
She rolled a natural 20.
Jesus, that was hot. Yeah, I'm gonna try to jump to her.
Okay.
Gotta limber up first. Stretch out the calves.
This is gonna go so poorly.
Natural 20 for love.
Can't watch.
Natural 20 for
love. Yeah. 4. Is this acrobatics or athletics?
It's athletics.
That's a 9.
The wall itself is slick, and as you push down, you lose your traction on the front, landing with a foot in the dirt, and Pike still 25 feet away from you.
Well, now Whitestone's got problems. And now we really can't solve them unless we make really deep cuts. So baby, show me that grog blood.
Push. put in some money.
This is my jam!
I will angle up. This time I would like the lightning to come from my ass.
Oh my god. You're William Wallace-ing it.
Yes, yes.
How can you even aim like that, Scanlan?
Oh, I have practiced aiming things with my ass in this campaign.
Yes, this is true.
Very true.
I'll inspire Pike. I'll turn to her and I'll say,
further.
I wish they all could be cleric gnomian girls.
All right, Pike, you get a D10 inspiration dice from Scanlan, a voice you've longed to hear for some time as your friendship has been so far away. So take your 1d10.
That Scanlan friendship.
Friendship. Oh, man.
All right, brings its club upward to the
air. As my reaction, I bring up my shawm, it's a horn, and I blow the note. The note is like Dumb and Dumber, the sound he makes. Like that most annoying sound. Just sort of mash all my fingers down.
Okay.
That's the note I blow.
So a 20, does that hit?
That hits.
All right, so. Horrible speaking sound. Okay.
Oh, my shawm!
You take, shawm is kind of bending. Not quite. You're probably gonna have to buy a new one or get that repaired.
Oh, no.
It brings up its club one more time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God.
13.
That misses!
This time, kind of bring its club up. You can see the arc and you.
I'm ducking down to work on the shawm.
Just swings completely out of your view.
What?
Where are you at, Scanlan?
You mean physically or mentally? Because I'm in love with you. Matt, while she's rolling, Wait. Can you just describe her hair at this moment? Is it whipping around? Is it in her face? Is it covering her eyes in sort of a sexy, sweaty way?
Matted with jam.
He's ignoring you.
The hair itself glistens against the rain. It almost doesn't even touch. Somehow immaculate in the middle of combat. You find it slow motion in your head. And
Can I faint?
Yeah.
I'm looking at clotheslines for any sort of beret type of a hat.
Not in this weather, not in this city.
Yarmulke, anything?
No. Nope. Okay. Whitestone, not really a beret kind of people.
Thank you.
Come here and give me a hug. I give her a hug. What happens?
Okay. It feels like you're grabbing almost like a warm, energetic gelatin in a way. Like her form isn't purely physical.
It's just how I remember you. Warm gelatin. Percy's thinking very clearly. He's fine.
He has a black smoke coming out of his body all the time.
I have lightning coming out of my ass.
Yeah, well, you choose to do that.
I put Vax's dagger in my back pocket.
As she's saying this, you look over and Scanlan almost looks at you directly and goes like, grabs your wrist and stops.
I use the other hand and I tweak his nose as hard as I can.
Come on, not in front of Pike.
And I pull it.
Oh. Yeah. You save the day again.
Mrs. Shorthalt, you are amazing. Pike, will you carry me over the threshold?
Scanlan's playlist on Spotify went up on the website. Yeah,
yes. That's baby making music right there, baby.
Yeah, there's some panty peelers in there too. Oh,
that's a terrible term.
That is my clothes really falling off.
I wrote it in the song description. You did. Somebody edited it out.
Really? Oh no.
Anything else you want to go over, or should
I? Sam, put your hand up by your face. Now high five me while I high five down on the count of three.
Wait, do I go up or down?
You're going straight down. Straight up. One, two, three. Did it work?
Did it work?
Did it
I gotta go lower. One, two, three.
Oh, so strong.
As always, friends with Worm.
The bear, kind of, which at this point has been barely visible, steps out of the shadows as well.
Barely.
It would be you.
Kill him. Kill him.
I run as fast as my little legs will take me. It's 25.
There you go.
I will inspire Vex. Arrows and bows they fire at our foes and kill them and I make them ghosts. They won't let go. Arrows and bows.
I continue my long journey into the room.
Just get past there.
Can I see how rough Vax is?
At a glance, it's kind of hard to tell from this moment.
I'm bleeding out my mouth.
He's also facing away from you.
Looks
he's facing
normal Anders. To me. you see, you see, this is the dawning of the age of Agrogius. The age of Agrogius. Agrogius. I take out my broken shawm, and I. And I cast counterspell on him.
Right, because you took that with your left
hand. Right.
Yeah!
Shit. Alright.
Wait, I have to tell a level, don't I?
Yeah, you can tell me what level it can be based on.
Do I know, because he's a bard, he's doing?
You know, you're very familiar with the spell, and it is a fourth level spell.
Then I cast it at fourth level.
Okay. And the doorway just slams behind him, and he's.
Uh-huh. That door is locked, motherfucker. Get used to it, because I am.
You'll get into melee with him if you do.
Well, then, what does that mean?
Meaning if you want to do any ranged attack or a spell attack roll, you would have disadvantage on it, but otherwise it has no effect.
He can attack you, though, because he's right next to you.
He won't be for long.
Okay.
So I get up close and they're like 5 feet away, and then I'll just thunder wave him.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
I do like that thing where frat boys do like the chest bump.
Like, come at me, bro.
Yeah.
Instead of using the table, though, you use Grog's knee. Okay. You just run, jump onto his knee with one foot, leap off, blade in the air, go for the strike.
That's cool.
Come on. Can do it, Scanlan.
What do I add?
Your attack bonus.
Attack bonus for your weapon.
I don't know what that is.
Never it is never used.
Okay, it's a plus 7.
Yeah, so.
15.
That hesitation was all needed. It takes the shield and almost knocks the weapon out of your hand. You catch yourself, land on your feet. Yeah, your fingers sting a little bit, but.
You guys, I thought someone was gonna kill him.
I tried, but he hurt my wrist really bad.
Just hit him with your.
We come back and say that Ripley is very talented. She got away. Dr. Ripley.
I have no doubt. Yeah. We have bigger issues than.
As soon as we see that, I go down in the crouch and I shit scry on our keep.
Shit in the kitchen?
Yeah. I put a mound of shit in a jar in the kitchen and I told him don't clean it up.
Yep. Like you do.
You know.
Like you do.
Thursdays.
I want to think.
My shit saw no movement.
Good to know,
any chance you can load up one of Ripley's guns for me?
I would have to probably train you on how to use it.
I've seen you use it. You just pull your finger on the finger part, and the big boom part goes out.
It's a little more complicated than that, actually.
You have to point it at the thing you want to be boomed.
I mean, he could use it.
I'll load one for you and make sure it functions, too. And
it seems pretty functional.
I'd like to make an athletics check. Or acrobatics, or athletics. See if I can spin it around and put it in my pocket.
Wait, where did you get it?
That would be a dexterity check.
Okay, I'll do that.
So no, you have it.
Yeah, give it to me.
Give it to him.
Careful, Alfie.
14.
Okay. You and managed to get it in there. Thankfully, it's not loaded because you feel the trigger go off.
Oh.
But there wasn't a bullet loaded, so it's like.
Oh, we took all the ammunition.
Okay, now give me a bullet.
Maybe don't do that.
I hand him the ammunition. I load four of them.
You're
giving him a load.
I'm a big boy. Well, I'm a little boy, but I'm a little
big
boy.
If something goes horribly wrong,
I would like to walk past Scanlan and grab it out of his hand.
What? I will prevent him from doing that. 17.
Shut up, 27.
As you go to be, no, what are you? It's already gone.
Because Grog, he's a Goliath.
He's what?
He's a big Goliath. So if he's here, you should just, you know.
How'd you see him?
Oh, when I was a dinosaur and I burned down a house and killed a bunch of people.
It's a series of words that I know
you
individually.
Fought him?
It strings them together.
I fought a Goliath.
Make sense.
I wouldn't say fought because I sort of beat him really easily and then I ran away.
Oh, you killed him?
No. I just pushed him off a building and then I thought that was enough for the day, so I went home.
At this point, Cassandra looks over her shoulder at this. It's a shame you're not as tall as your tail, small one.
Well,
Thank you.
No.
Take that as a compliment.
No.
You know that we have your back and yes. that we're with you in this 100%.
Yes.
But I'd like our enemies to know that as well. So with your permission, I will cast Seeming on all of us, and I make the girls look like Cassandra and the boys look like Percy. So I give us all
you
the white
crazy
hair.
You crazy motherfucker!
And if possible, I'd like to emblazon the sign of the rebellion on our chests in sort of a awesome Superman
like
glowing.
All right.
Can we all,
so.
That's awesome. Facts. Facts.
Yes, it's me.
Yes, Kayla, it's me.
Facts.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh.
I just.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, it's me, Vax.
Kiki,
what do you need? It's me.
Oh.
Kiki,
I'm over
here.
What is me? It's me.
Can we go?
Oh, sister Vax, do you mind giving me that gun again?
Shut up,
no.
Skip.
That'll be no, no. problem at all.
You can't have it.
Why? Because I'm 3 feet tall.
So what's the marching order here, guys?
We'll go Percy, Cassandra, Cassandra, Percy, 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 Cassandra.
Boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl.
And I just say,
this is from Jared Ray.
This is Percy beating up Percy right now.
That's totally true.
Yeah. You're being attacked and stabbed by yourself. It's weird. There?
Yeah, and I'll thunder wave them both. Ow, oh no, and I hit Trinket. Rip out someone's tongue and I'll know you. Kill someone dead and I'll show you got those moves with dagger. You got those moves with dagger. You got those moves like dagger. I vault over Keyleth's body using maybe like the right part of her butt cheek to like launch off of. Boom. Grab a little feel as I go.
Like a creepy gnome.
I will healing word Mr. Okay. Mr. Taliesin Jaffe. Percival DeRolo, Juanum, DeMonico, DeChico.
It's delightful. It's lovely.
Cameron, back me up. If you were to turn into some sort of, I don't know, you three-horned beast and go running into a like a house full of enemies.
Yes, yes.
We would give him a similar talking to, correct?
That would never happen. I'm more measured than all
of you. He would never do that.
We don't actually believe that he will listen to sense. So
I'm Percy. Grog, you suffer no poison damage. We have
immune
a meal.
Hero's feast.
And yes. Trinket ate it too.
Trinket did eat.
You
then,
smart that's
little
amazing.
Pimp.
They wouldn't build a huge bronze trap room within their castle. We've been beaten by doors before, but goddammit, we're not going to be beaten today. I go to the center of the room, and I find that little button thing.
This is completely unlike any other trap.
I'm going to press it.
Good.
It doesn't move. It doesn't shift.
It
doesn't give away. As you pull your thumb away, though, you notice that the gem has a very soft, faint white glow to it.
Can Trinket touch a stone?
Trinket
or
in the
Cassandra?
Middle.
Cassandra, make yourself useful, for Christ's sakes.
Advice.
Yeah, we guys have seven with Mike.
In,
yeah,
we have seven.
Neumolia, where I'm from. I step into the acid.
Okay.
And I start hitting the one in the center.
Okay.
With my fucking stupid sword.
You strike down, whoosh, arcing down the acid, splashes, parts of it kind of go across your face.
Not the face! Not the face!
Grab Pike, and the two of you, shoof, woof, appear on the other side of the glass.
Now's a good time to talk about us, don't you think?
Break the outside gem!
All I hear is.
Break the outside gem!
I think Percy wants us to kiss Pike.
Yes!
He said the power of love will inspire him.
You can fuck the power of love!
I'm gonna take a snorkel.
You go through and pop out on the other side in the hallway. Style.
Are there any buttons, knobs, levers?
Looking up, you do see immediately to your right in the hallway, there is a stone square with a push plate.
Motherfucker.
That's what he pushed. Push it!
Did I see
push it?
Vax push that?
We all did.
You saw Vax appear behind them and push something in that direction.
Okay, so I will push that.
Okay. The door that you swam under lifts up.
Guess I could have done that before. Sorry.
They're doing stuff on the top of the pyramid.
We don't know what's up there.
Can I see?
There's no inside?
You raise up and you look and
well,
a little bit of...
It's for grain storage.
A little bit of...
Roses are red, violets are blue. We're both gnomes and you are so
foxy.
Device, which I have made, that is on my hip, that I'm ready to begin using at a moment's notice.
It's a French tickler.
Yeah, I know.
It's the most ticklish French tickler you've ever seen, baby.
I mean, I'm just gonna.
Oh yeah.
I will. I'll use my bonus action to inspire Percy.
Okay.
And I'll just say, Percy's got a gun.
Oh really?
Percy's got a gun.
She wraps her arms around him, and they both.
I cast counter spell.
She is in range.
Oh! So I'll say, that's the sound of the gnome fucking with your spell. Yeah, yeah. 23.
And with that, she grasps him, the door begins to open, and then flickers.
Stay. Big Bass Hand!
Bam!
Give
her
that sexy hand.
I don't like her.
Okay.
So I'll just punch her in the face.
Okay.
Come on, big roll. 13 That's plus better. Nothing is 13.
All right. So I'm looking around and is like going from a fight position, almost like a cornered creature, to.
More. I'm going to try to cast suggestion on her.
Okay.
And I will say. Stop! Collaborate and listen, because I'm a gnome who's on a mission. Follow me as I kill your husband, the Lich, and I'll make you my bitch.
Husband was a vampire.
Oh, yeah. Whatever.
It didn't rhyme. It's fine.
I'm modeling one right now. It's so
rust.
It fits snugly and warmly, but not too warm. I think I would pay $50 for a sweater.
You look a little deadly in there, I will say.
It's got your poops right on it.
Yeah, yep. It does.
It keeps my poops nice
poops
and snug. Got two pockets for two poops.
You can't beat promotion like this, folks.
On what it originally was, Jesus Crit. That's what the holiday was always about.
No.
And now we're getting it back to Jesus Crit.
Oh, no. Yep. We'll leave it at that.
I want you to have my greater healing potion. It would mean so much to me if you would take it, drink.
Thanks, Scanlan.
No problem. Back over here, I'd give it to her, but. Not so. You're pretty cool too.
Thanks, buddy. What?
What about that gun?
Scanlan.
Just let me hold it.
Oh, he did just give you a potion.
I'm just letting you know. You're not skilled with range attacks.
There's nothing he can do with it anyway. I have all the ammunition.
I know.
You
can't
That's
do
what
anything
you think.
With it.
My pickpocket fingers are faster than you could ever imagine.
I really don't think they are.
I'll take that.
How did it go? Did you kill the little black thing of death?
No.
Scanlan, just don't.
No,
I didn't.
Don't do it. It's so stupid to do that.
What?
Bex
it's not
gave
loaded.
Scanlan a gun. I don't think it's loaded.
Oh God! Be careful.
Do
careful.
I look? Does it look cool?
No.
Can I just sort of check my history memory banks to see if I know anything about the Whispered One, or if that jogs any memory?
A religion check, Mr.
Burr. Religion check. Oh,
yes, the Whispers!
Whispers!
What? He's gone.
He's
Where
whispering
is he?
About the
this
Whispers.
Is, oh Jesus!
This is the pre-show days.
I'm so excited!
He's licking the inside of
Sam's
ear.
Look at his eyes.
Shh. It was all tongue in my ear the whole time. It
lucky,
was so
lucky
dirty.
Boy.
Oh, the whispered one. Yeah, it draws a. I have a memory. I don't know where I learned of this knowledge. I am very old. But I did. At some point in my travels, I remember reading about something. A lich? A lich king?
Oh, man.
Who wanted to be a god. And his name was Vecna, and they called him the Whispered One.
Oh, I go to retrieve this powder box
off the floor to give it to him, and I try to sneak out a bullet.
Different bullets. They
does it?
Help
I don't know that.
Make a sleight of hand check.
Yes.
Do it.
Three.
Shit.
You break
plus
it
two.
Further.
Plus two.
Okay, so five. Go ahead.
The three in theory is actually low enough to break it further.
So you watch as Scanlan kind of looks around.
Grabs it,
picks it up, and
oh.
the the full barrel comes off of the gun.
I just sort of back away from it.
You realize he's got smoke billowing out of him right now.
Just sort of kick it off away to the corner.
Scanlan, give me the other gun.
Oh, it's on the floor right there.
The other gun.
You were talking to something out there. What was it? I was very scared. I'm a little man. Who are you talking to?
I need another gun.
Are you gonna kill me with
it? Stop.
I get one too.
He whispers to you all the time.
It looks like there was more time with you, though, Sam. So.
Well,
shh.
We're just point that out.
I will just inspire Percy. You feel good in this motherfucker. Your whole hood in this motherfucker.
That's it.
19.
Okay, so 19. You're gonna make.
So I'm gonna say, you gonna fail that attack, so you better sit your ass on back, cause I ain't no holler back gnome. I ain't no holler back gnome.
As he says that, you're right. He is no holler back gnome. And you resist with the hammer, giving him just enough time to step out of the way, and boom, slams into the ground harmlessly, cracking the stone around the base.
You're right. There is no holler back gnome.
I will viciously mock it. I will say, don't you know, smoking is the number one cause of cancer and emphysema, and it will shorten your life by an estimated 10 to 20 years. It's not cool, and you shouldn't do it.
Is that all true?
I'm BSing.
Oh, okay.
What languages do you speak?
Gnome, common, that's it.
Okay. You get the sense you probably don't want to be close to it.
Okay. I charge at it. No.
That's the Scanlan I know and love.
That's always worked out so well.
Stealing word her, and I'll say, believe it or not, you're made mostly of air. I never thought you could feel so free. 8, honey, I love you.
Hey. I blow him a small kiss.
So whatever it is, I say, and another thing! Your smoking encourages minors to smoke and creates an aura that is, it makes going to restaurants not pleasant, and it's just horrible, makes your clothes stink, it's terrible. So another vicious mockery.
Please
let him die from this.
Suddenly you feel like you've damaged it mentally enough to the point where it doesn't even want to deal with you anymore. You're far too mean.
You're too mean.
Take that.
I think I may be all right.
Are you going to shoot your sister like you just pointed your gun at her, or what was that about?
Here, we'll make a deal.
I'll let you keep that gun if you give me the other one.
No.
I just had a thought, Percy. I cast friends on him. I think I know how to fix your gun if you hand it to me.
Never in my right mind would I hand my gun.
While they're talking, can I attempt to pull it off of his belt?
Pull it off of Percy's?
Percy's.
My insight is 21.
I rolled a natural 20.
Oh. You're gonna cost me so much money. I'm so upset that I have to do this.
Wink!
Yeah, role play for 3 minutes, Talzin.
I hand him the broken gun.
I say, thank you, Percy. I think in due time you will thank me for this. And I toss it into the ashes. As I say, when the spell fades, he's gonna be super pissed. Somebody protect me.
Okay.
You wanna hop on my shoulders?
Yes, okay. I go run and jump on.
As you watch it arc forward in your head, you're like, that fucking gnome. The spell fades, you hear him say that, and just as it, boom.
That was so expensive! That was so expensive! He's paying for a new one. I'm gonna have to, oh god.
As you're watching this, there's a small, from the fume, a small plume of black smoke goes.
See?
And that cold nugget in the center of your chest.
It was
is gone.
Oh! It feels good, doesn't it?
Doesn't it feel good?
You fucking genius!
It feels good.
That was so expensive.
Oh, come on.
I walk up to a particularly handsome widow and I say,
Oh God.
Your husband.
Pike is right here.
Oh. Your husband died for a good cause. Thanks, Pike.
Pike is shocked. Pike is shocked and offended. That you would have
sorry, Pike. Don't, why are you looking at me like that, Pike? Pike, stop it!
One of the soldiers walking with you kind of steps by your side looking at you curiously and gives her a kiss on the cheek. And just, oh. Who was that man?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, no, you.
Never saw you before, friend.
This is what I really wanted to see.
You have a lovely house, by the way, or had one. I find a young boy.
Yes, Scanlon?
Or a soldier. And I give him 15 gold. And I say, for the love of God, find me fucking beret.
A few moments pass before the boy returns, in his hand, a
raspberry beret. At a secondhand store.
Yeah, make it look cooler on him. He made it.
I don't think it's a beret. I don't think he made it, Dorothy. I think it comes with that already sewn in.
There it is. There it is. It looks good. It looks good, Scanlon.
You thank you, Scanlon. Young boy. Whatever your name was. What was your name, young boy? Thank you, Randall. You've made me a very happy small man.
He brings you the chain.
Oh no, keep the chain. It's all right. Go buy yourself a goose. The biggest goose in town.